a presentation of WGN Sports.
Wisconsin, and the roof is open once again tonight. Should be a beautiful night for Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN Sports. This is not a playoff series, but it certainly felt that way last night. A thrilling 6-4 win for the Cubs, and we are set for game two, the Cubs and the Brewers here on WGN Sports. Hi again, everyone. Bob Renly and Len Casper with you. The Cubs' lead in the division is now up to 2. Last night, there are a million things to talk about, but how about the ninth inning? The game actually ended twice.
Unbelievable the way that game ended. Giovanni Soto picking that foul ball out of the dirt, held it up to the umpire, and sold the home plate umpire on the call, but the base umpire saw it a little differently. Just an unbelievable ending to an unbelievable game.
The great slide by Reed Johnson. That was a key moment. The Cubs were able to score twice and avoid a big double play.
Yeah, the Cubs had the right guy running at first base on that play, because you know Reed Johnson's going to throw his body in harm's way to do whatever it takes to help his team win a game, and that was a huge turning point in the ballgame.
Derek Lee with a game-winning RBI on a double in the ninth, and as we look ahead to tonight, what a pitching matchup. Carlos Zambrano and Ben Sheets, they're good friends, but not tonight.
Not tonight, not at all. You see what Carlos has done since his return from the disabled list. Threw 125 pitches last time out, so he is locked, loaded, and ready to go.
And for the Brewers, I don't know who the ace is, whether it's Sabathia or Sheets, but they're both really, really good.
Well, Ben Sheets has been an ace against the Central Division this season, a perfect 6-0 record against teams in his own division.
All right, be another packed house tonight here in Milwaukee. If the Cubs can win, they will clinch being ahead and in sole possession of first place when they leave here on Thursday. Cubs and the Brewers, next.
Notice how digital's made pretty much everything better? Especially television. Digital TVs got better picture, better sound, more channels. In fact, digital's so much better that by law, all broadcast TV has to be digital by 2009. But there's a catch. Some TVs need an upgrade to get digital. You could even lose your signal. Get the facts. Visit DTVAnswers.com to learn about television switch to digital. Or call this number to see how you can stay connected.
You can settle down. You can fire it up. You can tune it in. But it's still not summer until you bring it out. Introducing Bud Light Lime. It's the superior drinkability of Bud Light with a splash of 100% natural lime flavor. One taste and you'll find the summer state of mind. It's in the lime. Bud Light Lime.
Ah, yes, the Geico Gecko in-migration. Driven by primal instinct to help people save hundreds of dollars on their car insurance.
Hey, do you see that guy over there? He's giving me the heebie-jeebies. Gotta be kidding me.
What a clever creature.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Chicago Cubs baseball, brought to you by Bud Light Lime. The superior drinkability of Bud Light with a splash of 100% natural lime. AMPM. AMPM. Too much good stuff. The Illinois Lottery. Play the Illinois Lottery. Have a ball. By Comcast. Proven advanced technology. Call 1-888-4-BEST-TV. By Pepsi. Every sip gets you closer. And by Southwest Airlines. Bees don't fly with us. Visit southwest.com.
at tonight's Cubs broadcast from Milwaukee here on WGN Sports is brought to you in beautiful high definition, sponsored by Comcast. Battle of all-star pitchers tonight. Big Z worked in relief. Ben Sheets in the all-star game. I think he's ready. Is he going to get on his back? Yeah, that's the new wrinkle. And as you check out Lou Piniella's Pepsi lineup against the Brewers, we'd like to tell Cubs fans, after your first sip of ice-cold Pepsi or Diet Pepsi at Wrigley Field, check for the Cubs sticker under the cap for your chance to win an overnight stay to the Abbey Resort and Spa on Lake Geneva. Grab an ice-cold Pepsi or Diet Pepsi from a Wrigley Field vendor and look under the cap for your chance to win with Pepsi and the Abbey Resort.
Take a look at the Brewers defensively behind Ben Sheets tonight. Braun, Cameron, and Hart once again across the outfield. Russell Brandon getting the start at third. J.J. Hardy at short. Recently acquired Ray Durham will be playing second base tonight. He's 2-for-10 as a member of the Brewers. Big Prince Fielder over at first base. Jason Kendall behind the dish once again tonight for right-hander Ben Sheets. 10-3 record, sparkling 287 ERA. This guy is definitely a strike thrower. Only 31 walks in 135 innings thrown so far this year.
So he's ready to work. And let's set the table. The standings look like this. The Cubs are two up on Milwaukee, three to go, including the night in this series. St. Louis, a blowout win at Atlanta. They trail 2-1 in the bottom of the third tonight. And they're four back. Alfonso Soriano had a big night last night. And he takes a curveball for a strike from Ben Sheets. So we're underway. Leadoff double, then a home run later for Soriano. He scored three of the Cubs' six runs, including the game winner in the ninth. And he waves a strike three.
Well, you've pretty much seen what Ben Sheets is going to do against the Cubs offense tonight. He's got a four-seam fastball that he likes to work across the top of the zone and away from hitters. A big over-the-top curveball breaks straight down to the ground. This is a legitimate 12-6 curve. Occasionally, he'll have trouble getting that ball down in the strike zone. He has surrendered 13 home runs this season, but when he's on top of that breaking ball, he's deadly.
Starts Terrio with a heater at 95. Ryan batting second. He was in the seven hole last night. The 0-1 pitch is outside. Sheets and Big Z like to work very quickly. Now it's 2-1. Ben Sheets was the first Brewers pitcher to start in the All-Star game. His numbers were very similar to Carlos Zambrano. But Sheets was chosen on the player's ballot. That's why Clint Hurdle decided to go with him. Z was a manager's choice. Full count on Terrio. Here's the pitch. Right back up the middle and a base hit. Almost took off the head of Ben Sheets.
You don't see a lot of two-strike base hits, rather, against Ben Sheets. Looking at his chart, every time he has two strikes on a hitter, the batting average is minuscule. On an 0-2 count, batters hitting 133. On a 1-2 count, 118. 2-2, the average is 154, and on full counts, it's 150. So obviously, if you're the Cubs offense, you want to do something before you get to two strikes in an at-bat.
Derek Lee with the biggest night for the Cubs last night. Two go-ahead RBIs, including the eventual game winner.
The other RBI tied the game on what could have been a double play ball. We had a shot of Ryan Terrio earlier. Ivan De Jesus is coaching first base for the second straight night. Matt Sinatra will be back tomorrow night. Matt serving a two-game suspension after he was ejected over the weekend. And that was the first major league ejection for Matt Sinatra as a coach or as a player.
A new member in our club.
Welcome to the fraternity. Ramirez on deck. One out, 2-1 on Derek Lee and a runner on first. We're just underway. Fly ball to right. Corey Hart's going back on this ball. He's on the warning track and he's going to get it. So Derek just missed.
Derek Lee was in the middle of everything last night. Dunked that ball down the right field line to score Soriano in the first inning. That was that fielder's choice ground ball. The great slide by Reed Johnson. Kosuke comes around to score. And then the slicing double down that right field line in the ninth inning. It looked like Terrio might have gotten drilled with that pickoff attempt right there.
It would have been a close play if Fielder had caught it cleanly. So here's Ramirez with two outs. Big swing and he fouled it back. I was thinking about Ryan Terrio last night, that great defensive play. His fielder got it to Sabathia. I think Ryan would have wanted to collide with either of those two Brewers players anywhere near the bag. He's running. The pitch is a strike. Kendall's throw, I think, hit Durham, possibly Terrio. At any rate, Ryan's going to end up at third. So his 16th stolen base, and there'll be an error in there, allowing him to advance one more bag. Meanwhile, 0-2 on Ramirez.
Tremendous jump by Ryan Terrio over there at first base. Ben Sheets is he's about average to home plate. He can be slow on occasion, but Terrio got such an awesome jump right there. I'm kind of surprised Jason Kendall even risked that throw to second base.
Kind of hard to tell if it hit the glove of Durham or if it caromed off Terrio.
You see that great jump. Kendall gets rid of it quickly, makes a throw that tails a little bit back into the runner.
Emergency swing there, and it's going to cost Ramirez an at-bat as Kendall makes a catch in foul ground. We get Sheets out of the top of the first. The Brewers offense will face Big Z when we come back.
Family tradition.
What's that?
The one where we pass our plates to the right.
When did that become a family tradition?
When you ordered that.
Try Olive Garden's new grilled garlic shrimp. Marinated shrimp topped with a roasted garlic glaze. Or try new grilled balsamic glazed chicken. Both served over angel hair pasta and homemade cream sauce. Two new grilled dishes with endless salad and breadsticks.
I think I like this new family tradition.
Olive Garden. When you're here, you're family.
That swore it would never get old, didn't. Welcome to the summer of life. And now there's an official hair treatment of the summer of your life. New Touch of Gray from Just for Men. Let you keep a little gray. Works gradually. Just comb in, rinse.
Never trust anybody over 90.
Keep a little gray with New Touch of Gray.
Increase power. power, performance, and gas mileage with Prestone Fuel System Cleaner and save up to $396 on the deal. Whatever you're working on, Advance will help you keep the wheels turning.
Brewers mascot Bernie Brewer trying to get this crowd charged up. I don't think they need a lot of motivation, though. Ray Durham recently acquired in there for Ricky Weeks tonight. Hardy, Braun, Fielder, 2-4. It's Hart, Brannion in there for Hall, Cameron in center, and the battery, Kendall and Sheets.
Take a quick look at the Cubs defensively, brought to you by Pepsi. Soriano, Fukudome, and DeRosa across the outfield. Ramirez, Terrio, Fondo, Lee across the infield. We've got our graphics a little turned around there. Giovanni Soto's not playing center. He's catching, but Carlos Zambrano's on the mound. We know that for sure.
As Ray Durham fouls away. Carlos going after his 12th win. That's a gapper for Durham. And it'll be a single to start it for the Brewers. Brings up J.J. Hardy. Ray Durham earlier this year with the Giants was 10 for 24 with a homer and six RBIs against the Cubs.
He's a base-stealing threat on over there at first base, 6 out of 8 on the season. He's had a number of nagging injuries that have kept him from running as much as he normally would.
That's a double play ball, 5-4-3. Hardy hit it right at Ramirez, and they turn it.
As quickly as the Brewers felt they had some momentum with that leadoff hit by Ray Durham, Zambrano erases that momentum with an easy ground ball double play to Aramis Ramirez at third base. And when he's got his good sinker working, Carlos needs his infield defense to make plays for him. If he's got that good downward late movement, he's going to get a lot of ground balls.
Brings up Ryan Braun. Game-tying homer in game one. Fouled back. They hit back-to-back homers in the sixth. Hardy and then Braun to tie it against Ted Lilly. Lilly went toe-to-toe with CC Sabathia. It was a quality start. He gave up all three of his runs in the sixth. And the Cubs scored four times against Sabathia. Three were earned. They had 9 hits. Not a bad start by Sabathia, but considering what he had done lately, you have to feel really good about what the Cubs were able to do against him. As he dropped down that time.
Ryan Braun has been on some kind of a tear over his last 6 ball games, 13 for 22 with 5 home runs. And you see his numbers against the Cubs this season. They may have discovered something, however, in the 8th inning last night. Chad Godin came in and absolutely blew Ryan Braun away with some fastballs.
Blown away there by Zambrano. 94 here in the first inning. Nothing.
That's me, Dr. John Dorian. My friends call me JD.
Look what I confiscated from one of the kids in pediatrics.
Ow!
Not too hot?
Yeah! I'm an intern at a hospital that could use a little therapy.
They're doing a breast reduction on 3, and I want to get up there and try and stop it.
In fact, sometimes things around here are so strange, they can make a TV show about it.
There's no beer.
We had a beer.
Newsflash, you can't drink and then come to work. You're not airline pilots.
They could call it Scrubs.
I'm no Superman.
Nah, my job is right here.
Sorry, if that gets infected, I'm a doctor.
Saving lives at Sacred Heart.
Is anybody else a doctor? What's going on down there?
Scrubs, 7 nights a week at 11 East, 8 West.
mathematically possible that such a huge treat is just $2.49?
If I only had a brain.
The Peanut Buster Parfait from Dairy Queen. Creamy DQ soft serve, crunchy peanuts, and hot fudge for just $2.49.
Welcome to Progressive.com.
Honey, what's all this?
Insurance.
Progressive motorcycle insurance.
Yeah.
RV insurance?
Uh-huh.
Boat insurance. But we don't have any of those things.
Well, actually, I do.
We do.
We do.
Surprise! Let's bag these up.
Saving you money so you can buy more toys. Now that's Progressive. Call or click today.
WGN America, TV you can't ignore.
Kosuke Fukudome leading off the second. He's batting fifth. That's where he was to start the season. I love the stories here about the makeup of the crowds. To start this series, last night, everybody talked about how many Brewers fans were here. We're in Milwaukee. The point of it was that it used to be that there would oftentimes be more Cubs fans than Brewers fans, but that's changed. There are Cubs fans here. That's Braun going after it, and he'll get it on the move to retire Kosuke. Ryan Braun making the conversion from third to left this season.
Nice running catch by Braun, not known for his leather out there in left field, still somewhat learning the position, and a tough play for him. Slicing line drive off the bat of Fukudome over toward that left field line, and Braun reaches up the last instant, makes a nice running catch.
Ball one on Mark DeRosa. Well, both managers, even the losing manager, said it was a fantastic ball game. And Ned Yost talked about how it was a good experience for his team. Had that playoff-like atmosphere. He'd like to see his team get used to that as that liner's caught. Cubs have hit the ball hard here in this inning, but both times for outs. Lou is very happy, obviously, with his team winning 6-4. In fact, I would say Lou even looked a little happier than normal. Not to read too much into it, but how could you not feel good about a win in such a great atmosphere like that?
Yeah, I think Lou was borderline giggly last night after the ball game. His players did a lot of good things in the game, and considering everything that was at stake, you want to win that first game of a big series like this, and Cubs came through.
Mike Fontenot again right in the middle of the game-winning rally. As a pinch hitter, he walked in the ninth and would score a run. The day before, he beat the Marlins as a pinch hitter with a three-run double. Two and oh the count. 83 degrees tonight. The roof is open. A very comfortable night. Overcast skies. And if we have the threat of rain, they can close it up.
You get to hear that wonderful sound of metal on metal. This roof does not operate as smoothly as some of the retractable roof stadiums in baseball, at least the last time I was here when they closed it.
Ball four to bring up Soto, who's batting eighth. The first walk given up by Ben Sheets.
How about this stat, Lynn? Ben Sheets had six starts in the month of May. He walked a grand total of two batters in 43 and a third innings pitch. I mentioned at the top of the show, normally he's a strike thrower. Curveball can be a little inconsistent around the strike zone, but usually if he wants to throw a strike fastball, he'll pound away at that outside corner.
This is the first time all season Soto's batted eighth. 1-1.
I mean, normally you see a power pitcher like Ben Sheets, basically a two-pitch guy, fastball, curveball. And you would assume at some point he's going to plunk a hitter or two just to keep him off of that breaking ball. He has yet to hit a batter this season. Does have four wild pitches. I would assume most of those have come on curveballs in the dirt.
Z on deck, hitting 356. Outside, 2-2.
Just kind of keep an unofficial count in your own mind how many times you say that. Misses away or fastball on the outside corner. Doesn't really like to challenge the right-handers in very much.
Good patience by Gio to make it 3-2, and now Fontenot will be running with the pitch because two are out. So Fielder will play behind him. Sheets has a sign from Kendall. And a full count pitch, a bouncer foul.
After talking about Ben Sheets' control and how good he's been this season, I'm sure there are a lot of Cub fans out there saying, well, wait a minute. He walked 7 Cubs earlier this year. That came in a start back on April 29th when he went 5 innings, gave up 3 hits and 4 runs, struck out 2, walked 7.
Fontenot goes again, swing and a miss. That ends the inning. 2 strikeouts for Sheets early on. Still no score.
Introducing Bud Light Lime. The superior drinkability of Bud Light with a splash of 100% natural lime flavor.
What my life is like and managing my diabetes is very complicated.
Simplify your life with a free Breeze 2 meter and a free 10 test disc from Bayer. Call 1-800-582-3131 or visit breezemeter.com.
You're twisting and turning a lot as to what should I do first. I need to talk to this client, but I'm feeling a little dizzy. I think I better check my blood sugar. So it's that kind of back and forth that feels like a tornado sometimes. I fell in love with the 10 test disc. The Breeze 2 is the best. It helps me with everything else in the day to just fall in line.
Only the Breeze 2 meter from Bayer comes with a unique, easy-to-use disc, so you only load strips every 10 tests, and you never have to code your meter to make testing simple.
I'm Suzanne Lipinski, and finding balance is my simple win.
Get your free Breeze 2 meter with a free 10 test disc. Call today, 1-800-582-3131, or visit breezemeter.com.
Introducing Bud Light Lime. The superior drinkability of Bud Light with a splash of 100% natural lime flavor.
In the tradition of great police dramas comes a show that's not even close to any of those shows.
Slipped in poop.
It's a crime.
Never actually kicked a lock on.
But they're cops.
Reno 911. Friday night at 1 East, 10 West on WGN America.
Hey, fans, next Monday, August 4th, is 70s night at Wrigley Field. Pull out your disco shirts and platform shoes and come celebrate with Michael McKean, who played Lenny on Laverne and Shirley. The Cubs take on the Astros at 6:05. 70s night is brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Fans dressed in the best 70s outfits will receive airline tickets, compliments of Southwest Airlines.
I guess he's in town and he'll play at Steppenwolf Theater. He also played David St. Hubbins. And this is Spinal Tap.
Yes, indeed. Actually, it's the second best 70s costume because we know you're going to have the best.
Fielder had a couple of hits, scored once in the opener. 8-for-26 against Zambrano as he bounces it foul.
Well, you know, we talked about it last night throughout the ballgame. Led a lot of power up and down this Brewers lineup. Braun with 29. Russell Branion has 12. Mike Cameron with 15. Fielder with 20. Hall with 14. Hardy with 15. Hart with 16. A lot of power up and down the lineup. But I think you have to get that ball in on their hands early in the game. Make them aware that you're going to come inside hard. That may open up that outside part of the plate in subsequent at-bats in the ballgame.
And he walked him. So the leadoff man has been on in each of the first two innings for the Brewers. Rothschild, the pitching coach, looking on, along with Alan Trammell, the bench coach. Jeff Samardzija should be available tonight. Was off last night. Carlos Marmol would be good for an inning. Not going to see Chad Godan. Three consecutive decisions for Godan. There's a base hit to center. So a walk and a single, setting it up for Russell Branyan.
Corey Hart, a guy that's grounded into 10 double plays this year, gets up on top of a high Zambrano fastball and tomahawks it into center field.
Pinch hit home run for Branyan while Bob Howry in the bottom of the seventh Monday night. That tied it up. He hit it into the bullpen in left center. When he got called up in late May, jumped into a platoon with Bill Hall. Big swing and a miss. It's because Hall has really struggled against righties this year. Branyan's hitting 290 versus righties, 0 for 14 versus lefties. Hall hitting a buck 71 against right-handers. And normally the teams the Cubs play put as many lefties into the lineup against Carlos as possible.
I'll tell you, this should be an overmatch for Carlos Zambrano. If he can keep that fastball up there above the belt, preferably on the inside part of the plate, or in that case, bounce a breaking ball in the dirt. Branyan has a lot of holes in his swing, but if you make that mistake out over the plate where he can extend his arms, he can do some damage, as he proved last night. That ball hits just behind the point of home plate. Nice block by Giovanni Soto to keep it in front. But Branyan is one of those guys that has areas you can attack. And if you can consistently execute your pitches, you can usually keep him quiet.
Mike Cameron's 0 for 8 with three strikeouts versus Z. Takes a strike. Struggling lately at the plate, just 4 for his last 32. Derek Leal just watched this ball drop into the seats.
Well, and hopefully the Cubs will be able to get into town, win some ball games, and get out of town before Cameron heats up, because he's one of those streaky types of hitters that will go through a 4 for 32 and then turn around and put an 18 for 25 on the board with about 4 or 5 home runs in a week. So definitely want to keep him in this slump until the Cubs get out of town.
Called strike three on a fastball for the second out. So they got the first two on, but Z has come back with back-to-back Ks.
Boy, just a challenge fastball right there. Ball right on the inside part of the plate. Cameron just locks up. Yeah, it looked in the ballgame last night. I mentioned the at-bat Ryan Braun against Chad Godan. It looked like in certain circumstances, some of the Brewers hitters were looking for off-speed pitches. Now, of course, they were facing Ted Lilly early in the game last night, and maybe their approach going in was to be ready to hit an off-speed pitch, but they took a lot of center-cut fastballs for strikes in the game last night.
Kendall's been an Iron Man this year, as he normally is. This is his 96th start. He's the only catcher in the majors to make at least 130 starts each of the last 6 years.
Well, besides his manager, you know who appreciates that, are the pitchers on this Brewers staff. Boy, there's something to be said for the consistency of having the same catcher back there almost every day. He knows your strengths and weaknesses. Obviously, Jason Kendall, a very good student of the game, knows the advance reports.
Terry will flip. Fontenot covering second, and that gets Carlos out of the second inning. They put the first two on, but he got the next three. Still scoreless.
Hey! No, 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 no! No!
Every sip gets you closer. Justin Timberlake MP3s.
Hey.
KDU. HDTVs. Millions of songs from Amazon MP3 and more. Sign up at PepsiStuff.com.
So, Kate, why are you an Esurance customer?
Esurance is the only auto insurance that makes me feel automated. My life is kind of busy. Sometimes it's hard to find what I need. Like my insurance cards.
With Esurance, there's no more paperwork.
Everything's online, where it's easy to find. That means insurance customers like me save a lot of paper, which also helps our environment.
Get your fast, free online quote today.
It's animated. That's your auto insurance with Esurance.
Maria Bergman's Nature Valley. Lost Horse Creek. Bitterroot Range, Montana. Where's yours? 100% natural, whole grains, delicious. Nature Valley granola bars, the energy bar nature intended.
Digest Quit Smokes. You won't make it till 6 o'clock? You got yourself a bet.
It'll be like taking candy from a baby. Yeah. Cranky and smoky, baby.
Next, Becker.
Just pathetic.
Becker, tonight at 1230 East, 930 West on WGN America. Reno 911. Friday night at 1 East, 10 West on WGN America.
Who do we think that is? Maybe Stormin Gorman?
That looks like Gorman. Maybe Robin Yount. He had that Fu Manchu working back in his playing days.
Switch hitting Carlos Zambrano against Ben Sheets. Fielder backhands. Sheets will get over to cover. Not a great throw by Fielder, but Sheets was able to get it. So Zambrano's out.
Carlos hit it hard, but a nice play by Prince Fielder. Moves a couple steps to his right to corral that one. That throw to Ben Sheets was low. That's always a concern when you have that pitcher running over there to cover first base, and at the last instant, he has to bend down below knee level to catch that throw. But it looked like Sheets came out of it okay.
I was listening to one of the radio post-game shows here in Milwaukee last night, and they were really getting on Ricky Weeks, who went 0 for 4. Last night, now hitting 224 on the season, made that critical error on what could have been a double play ball in the seventh inning. And he also did not make a play earlier in that inning. A ball went off his glove. They gave Fukudome an infield hit. So there were calls for Ray Durham to be in the lineup. I can tell you Ned Yost probably didn't listen to the radio shows of Soriano singles, but he did put Durham in the lineup. There's no better place for Cubs fans to hold an event than Harry Carey's Italian Steakhouse in Chicago, Rosemont or Lombard, or Harry Carey's Tavern in Wrigleyville. Call 773-HOLY-COW or visit harrycareys.com to plan your event today. Soriano off and running. Here's a throw covered by the shortstop, Hardy. And Soriano's in. Got his hand in. So they've stolen a couple against Jason Kendall, who had been over 41% on the season. One of the better catchers in baseball this season, throwing out base stealers.
However, this is not a good throw from Jason Kendall. He pulls it to that shortstop side. Took a good hop for him back toward the bag. A nice pick by J.J. Hardy, but Soriano with too much speed gets in underneath the tag at second base.
So he's 9 for 10 in the stolen base category. Good to see Alfonso running. Has shaken off the rust fairly quickly. Up the middle, not hit hard. And Hardy's throw is going to be in time. Wow, I thought he got in there. No argument from Ivan De Jesus. So two outs, runner at third.
J.J. Hardy showcasing his range up the middle of the field. That ball hit right over the pitcher's rubber, bounces to the second base side of the bag. Very close. Torrio coming out of that box. No watch, just run. I never understood that, why certain runners would watch the throw from the infielder coming to first base. You want to get there before the ball does. And you know where the throw is going to go. It's going to first base, and that's where you're going too. So just put your head down and run straight through the bag.
Leaf line to the warning track out in right his first time. Nothing in two. Kicking the pitch, blown away. Well, that's a fastball, but from our vantage point, where Kendall catches it, it almost has breaking ball action. It's that far low and outside. When you see catchers almost reach behind themselves to make a catch, you kind of have that sweeping feeling. But as you said, Ben Sheets with his fastball, he likes to try to stay away from those power-hitting right-handers. Swing and a miss. Went with the high four-seamer to get D. Lee. He has a strikeout in each of the first three innings. Bottom three, it'll be Sheets to start it against Z.
Who is Dave Chappelle? Really? He's Rick James. Lil Jon, Blackzilla, a Black Klansman, a Milkman, Tron Carter, Silky Johnson, Gallagher, Prince.
Here's the celebration.
Chappelle's Show, Friday night at midnight East, 9 West, on WGN America.
Bud Light is brewed to give you everything you want in a beer. Never-ending refreshment, superior drinkability, and now, X-ray vision. X-ray vision no longer available in Bud Light.
Let's go somewhere else.
The superior drinkability, however, remains.
Bud Light keeps it coming.
Become one with molten chocolate. Celebrate your right to indulge. It's time for Warm Delights Minis. Just seconds in the microwave, 150 calories, and you'll see how something so many can take you so far.
We're in the bottom of the third inning.
You got Sheets against Zambrano. You better run for the gate.
On the mound, it's pretty evenly matched. At the plate, not so much. As you could tell. Sheets is hitting 13 points better this season than his career 078 average. Ball 1-2. He's even it up. Durham and then Hardy to follow.
We used to say guys that were batting in the 100s were on the interstate. I-75, I-94. When you're in the zeros, you're a secret agent. Agent 091.
Cubs fans, don't forget to check out our WGN baseball blog on WGNTV.com. Click on the sports link. Look for Len and Bob's baseball blog. Up on the blog tonight, Bob has a post titled RBI Reed Busted It. Talking about that great slide last night. He knows what I'm talking about. Shaking his head, yes. Check out our updated podcast, game notes from our friends at Stats, and our new Baseball Buddy feature. Once again, WGNTV.com. Click on sports. Look for the link to Len and Bob's blog and our current podcast.
You know what a fan I am of the little things in the game that help your team win a ball game. Obviously, you need the big things, too. You need some home runs. You need some well-pitched games. You need your bullpen to do their job. Those clutch two-out RBI. But, boy, Reed Johnson with just an absolutely perfect example of what some hustle on the bases and playing the game the right way will do for a team.
I like his little tip. Ball gets hit to the left side, slide to the left, hit to the right side, slide to the right, beat the guy to his spot.
And you try to anticipate where that middle infielder is going to go. And that's why the middle infielders on occasion will try to mix it up a little bit, not go to the same area all the time.
3-1 on Durham. Rich Harden will pitch Thursday in the finale against Dave Bush, and we'll have it for you here on WGN Sports. 1 o'clock Central Time at Feld Durham. Pounded the dirt a couple of times. That's how much it hurt.
Well, I mentioned the little nagging injuries that just always seem to plague Ray Durham and keep him off the field for not necessarily extended periods of time, but foul balls off the ankle will cause you to miss a couple of ball games. You can see Ned Yost grimacing in the background.
Is there a guy you can think of who you managed, have watched, played with, who did that more than anybody else? Anyone in particular?
I'd have to think about that in a while. I think it happens to pretty much everybody at some point, but usually it's the guys that take the big swings, try to get the bat head out front, pull the ball, and occasionally get over and on top of the baseball and foul it right down off that front foot. The one guy that was really unusual to me was Matt Williams fouled it off his back foot more than anybody else I ever saw.
Swing and a miss. He was 3-0 on Durham. He comes back to strike him out as Durham kind of limps back into the dugout.
Like a good slider down and in from Zambrano. Started it on the inside part of the plate in the strike zone. Broke it out of the strike zone down low and in. Boy, especially after a guy's fouled a ball off his front ankle and you go right back into that same zone again. Kind of a tentative swing that time on the two-strike count from Durham.
Then you have the one where you foul it off your back knee. Didn't that happen to Derek recently?
Yeah.
Well, he's still not right. Talking about Ray Durham. Getting looked at in the dugout.
Getting back to that double play breakup by Reed Johnson on Ricky Weeks last night, it reminded me of a wide receiver going across the middle of the field in football, knowing that that middle linebacker was ready to break his rib cage. See those guys get the gator arms, they shorten up and protect their rib cage. There's no question that Ricky Weeks knew that Reed Johnson was right on top of him. He tried to go off the back of the bag at second to use the base to protect himself. Reed paid no mind to that base. He went right over it.
Swing and a miss on a nasty slider from Zambrano. 5 K's for him. Pitcher's duel tonight. No score.
Join the Night Watchman as he secures the fortress in an ongoing quest to keep it safe from mediocre television. Travel deep down to the movie underground to screen another movie mined fresh from the vaults. This Friday, we got the best Bond, and we're showing you his first outing as the infamous 007.
Bond. James Bond.
Pierce Brosnan stars in GoldenEye. Enter the movie underground Friday night at 80s 5 West right here on WGN America.
Shaken. Mustard.
I want, I need, I want, I need. was unlucky in love.
Will you marry me?
No.
What?
Until he found just the ticket. Yes. But it wasn't until he got on the wrong love boat.
It's a gay cruise, Jerry.
That he fell for the right crew member.
Are you okay?
I'm fine. She's a classic man hater.
Now he'll do anything to get what he really wants.
Me? Straight? Girlfriend, please.
Cuba Gooding Jr. Vivica A. Fox.
You want to get back together?
Well, I did. Before I found out that you were, you know.
How could you think I'm gay?
Boat trip.
Thursday at 8.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced nor retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs.
Middle of the order now for the Cubs. Ramirez, Fukudome, and DeRosa, right center for Aramis, as Cameron can't get it. And Ramirez rounding second, stopping there. Aramis didn't stop. He slowed down, however. They'll score it a double. If Cameron does get it, I think he keeps him to a single. He just couldn't get it.
That ball's hit like a bullet right over the head of Ray Durham at second base. Really scoots through that outfield grass. And I agree with you. I think if Cameron makes the play right there, stops his momentum quickly, Ramirez probably has to hold at first base, but as it is, he's in scoring position for Kosuke Fukudome.
Ball one. Jim Edmonds told his manager he was ready to go tonight. Some lingering left knee soreness. But Lou wanted to give him one more day. We saw Jim in the lineup on Sunday, but not last night. Kicks away from Kendall. That allows Ramirez to get to third. He's there with no outs.
Fifth wild pitch of the season for Ben Sheets. Talked about that big breaking ball when he bounces it in the dirt. It's such an unpredictable pitch to block, and that one got by Jason Kendall all the way to the backstop. You know, back on the topic of Jim Edmonds trying to talk his way into the lineup tonight. Pretty easy to give him one more day of rest when he's hitting 204 against the opposing pitcher.
Fouled back.
Although Edmonds does have three home runs against Ben Sheets, but he's 11 for 54 lifetime.
Infield is in, not all the way. Three and two.
I think that's probably based on the speed of Aramis Ramirez at third base. If you have a burner down there, somebody that can really scoot, you probably bring him all the way in. Recently, Kosuke has been squaring up a few more balls, hitting some line drives, some hard ground balls. When he was going poorly, he was hitting a lot of lazy fly balls to medium depth outfield. We take that lazy fly ball right now to drive home Ramirez from third base.
Just fouled it. Still 3-2. Biggest problem for Ben Sheets in his career has been remaining healthy. But going into this season, he was actually a game under 500, believe it or not. Popped into left, and that brings Braun way in. Ramirez, in fact, not even tagging. He went just a few steps down the line. So one out. And it's time for our AT&T text poll question from the land of cheese. We asked, which Wisconsin team do you dislike the most? You can text to 97999. A for these Brewers, B for the Packers, C for the Bucks, D for the Wisconsin Badgers, E the Marquette Golden Eagles.
I can't imagine. How can anybody dislike the Golden Eagles?
Poll brought to you by the new AT&T. See what's new at the new AT&T. Visit att.com for details. Mark DeRosa deep to center. Cameron is going to track it down. That'll be a sacrifice fly for Mark. And the Cubs lead 1-0.
With two solid at-bats in the game already by Mark DeRosa, a line drive to J.J. Hardy, his first trip to the plate back in the second inning, and this ball is crushed to straightaway center, chasing Mike Cameron all the way back to the warning track in front of the 400 mark. Ramirez can tag and walk home on that.
Nobody on. It's Fontenot with two outs, strike one. I should note there are a lot of Chicago area Marquette alums. Just point that out. I would say Packers and Brewers would probably be at the top of that list. I'm not sure in which order. One from Sheets. Bounced foul. Nice play by former infielder Ivan De Jesus, now a Cubs special assistant, filling in at first. Cubs have had three first base coaches this week. Matt Sinatra, Gerald Perry, and now Ivan De Jesus. Cameron coming in. He'll get it on the move. Makes a couple of grabs in the inning. One was a sack fly hit by DeRosa, and it's 1-0 Cubs.
At Sacred Heart Hospital, our doctors are among the best in the nation.
Is anybody else a doctor?
Scrubs, 7 nights a week at 11 East, 8 West on WGN America. Brought to you in part by Vagisil, 100% woman, 100% of the time.
The old, pour in the new. Get Advance Auto Parts 50-50 antifreeze for just $6.98 a gallon. Sale ends August 30th. So whatever you're working on, Advance will help you keep the wheels turning.
Become one with molten chocolate. Celebrate your right to indulge. It's time for Warm Delights Minis. Just seconds in the microwave, 150 calories, and you'll see how something so many can take you so far.
The men of TV are de-evolving. From man of the house...
I am the king in my castle.
...to man of the couch.
Haven't I heard of you?
You're not a cop, are you?
Just when you think it can't get any worse, these guys show up.
I'm Larry. This is my brother Daryl. That's my other brother Daryl.
Watch the men of classic TV go from sophisticated to sauced. Put your mind on rewind with Out of Sight Retro Night on WGN America. Keep your eyes here.
Chicago Cubs baseball from Milwaukee on WGN Sports. Your official summer baseball station is brought to you by Bud Light. Endless refreshment from start to finish. Bud Light keeps it coming.
Game two of a big four-game series. The Cubs took the opener 6-4. They ended up having three leads last night. They get the first run again tonight. 1-0 on Ryan Braun. Base hit. So first batter of the inning getting on now for the third time in the first four innings.
Braun, another guy you have to pay some attention to over there at first base. 9 out of 12 on the season, stealing bases. He picks his spots pretty well. And I wouldn't expect him to run early in the sequence here with Prince Fielder at the plate. When you have a left-handed pull hitter at the plate, you want to give him that hole on the right side of the infield as long as you can. Maybe if the count gets to two strikes, you'll see Braun on the move.
We want to wish the Peoria Chiefs lots of luck tonight. The road to Wrigley ends at the friendly confines this evening. And Ryan Sandberg back in uniform managing the Midwest League Class A affiliate of the Cubs. And they're leading Kane County 3-1 in the top of the third. Starting pitcher tonight for the Chiefs, Audie Santana. A right-hander.
And a connection to the Brewers in that game. Jameel Weeks, the younger brother of Ricky Weeks, playing for Kane County.
Playing second base and leading off for the Cougars, who are managed by Aaron Nikula. Not sure if I'm pronouncing the name correctly, but he grew up a Southside Cubs fan. I'm sure he's excited to be there tonight. 2-1 on Fielder, a runner at first, Braun. The Cubs got the lead on a Mark DeRosa sacrifice fly in the top of this inning. Him up on the infield for Ramirez. I'll tell you, Fielder took about four steps towards first base. Alamas didn't see it. Not that you're going to necessarily drop it on purpose, but he might have had a shot at a double play just to make a point.
Something to file away for future reference, however. That little pop up to the left side, and Fielder, as you said, only got a few steps out of the batter's box, was still carrying his bat, and Braun, of course, had to hold over there at first base. He'd let that one drop. There's a chance to turn two.
I mean, you don't want to get too cute and make a mistake, but they would have gotten Braun at second. And even if Fielder is safe at first, you take that exchange.
Absolutely. You take that trade off. Speed on the bases in Braun. Fielder, not quite so much.
It's pulled outside 2-1. And maybe a fan out there saying, well, when do you call the infield fly rule? It has to be first and second or the base is loaded for that play to be the infield fly rule. And at that point, he doesn't have to run. Once they put the umpire puts his arm up, the batter's out. But not with a runner at first. 2-2. Carlos chopping on that gum, as always. And his 2-2 pitch. Got him. Called strike three.
Just low fog right there. Hard sinker on the outside corner, down around the knees. Another Brewer hitter that takes a called strike on a fastball. Usually those two strike counts, hitters are a little more defensive. You just try to get a piece of that fastball and stay alive, unless a pitcher makes a mistake, of course.
Oh, man. The barrel of that bat hit the very corner of the netting behind home plate.
Keep beating that same old horse, but the day is going to come when that turns into a tragedy. Fortunately, that bat caught the very corner of the netting, as you mentioned, but just inches away from a spear flying into the stands over there on the first base side.
0-2. Since Carlos moved into the starting rotation permanently back on July 1st of 02, he has 49 road wins. That's tied for first in the majors during that span with Johan Santana, now of the Mets. He's 5-4 on the road this season, 6-0 at home.
And with a changeup last time, it is again.
Ground ball to Fontenot. A short throw to get Z out of the inning. Again, they put the leadoff man on three times, but still being shut out.
Every sip gets you closer to Justin Timberlake MP3s.
Hey, I like
Katie. HD TVs, millions of songs from Amazon MP3, and more. Sign up at PepsiStuff.com.
Get Pepsi Stuff points on specially marked Pepsi or Diet Pepsi 24-ounce six-packs for a free Amazon MP3 music download.
Hi, welcome to Progressive.com.
Honey, what's all this?
The insurance.
Progressive Motorcycle Insurance.
Yeah.
RV insurance?
Uh-huh.
Boat insurance. But we don't have any of those things.
Well, actually, I do.
We do.
We do.
Surprise! Let's bag these up.
Saving you money so you can buy more toys. Now that's Progressive. Call or click today.
Performance, exceptional control, destination tires with Unity technology, only from Firestone.
Digest quick smoke. You won't make it till 6 o'clock. You got yourself a bet.
Like taking candy from a baby. Yeah.
Next, Becker.
Becker tonight at 12:30. WGN America, your summertime home for baseball.
Cubs lead the Brewers 1-0. And Soto feathers one into center. That's a base hit. Voting for the finalists in the ultimate seventh inning stretch competition is going on now. Visit Cubs.com and help determine who you think should sing the seventh inning stretch at the Cubs game on September 1st. New videos will be posted daily, with each day producing a new finalist, so don't forget to keep visiting Cubs.com and vote for who you think deserves the title of Ultimate Cubs Fan. That's a foul ball. Well, you hate to almost give up Carlos in this spot. Look at those numbers at the plate.
The numbers for Carlos Zambrano as a hitter and the five Milwaukee Brewers starters combined. Carlos has one more hit than all five starters on this Brewers staff.
Already squaring. Popped it up and it'll be caught by Branyon. He just broke his bat over his knee.
Everything is good. He just picked a high pitch to bunt right there. I'll tell you, that's how brittle those maple bats are. It used to take a lot of work to break a bat over your knee. Carlos broke that bat like he was snapping a number two pencil.
I'm glad the bat broke and not his knee.
Yeah.
Swing and a miss. Big deal. Soriano with three hits in the series and two steals. To give him credit, he took a big walk in the ninth inning against Solomon Torres. He's not the most patient hitter on the planet, but in a key spot, was able to work that walk.
Unbelievable stop that time by Jason Kendall. Watch where this ball hits him. Up by the left shoulder. As a catcher, you're so concerned with blocking that five hole to make sure the ball doesn't scoot, stay down, and get underneath. And that time it hit him clear up on the left shoulder.
Soto began the inning with a single and then Zambrano fouled out on a bunt attempt. Sheets with his 2-2. We'll do it again. Back to Sheets for a moment. Going into the season, 73-74 in his career, in spite of a very solid 3.83 earned run average. He's 10-3 this year. He went 12-5 last season in 24 starts. A lot of that has to do with the fact that early in his season, he was on subpar teams. Both he and C.C. Sabathia should make a lot of money. They already have, but they're going to make a lot more starting next season. They're both due to become free agents.
I was going to say, Sheets is really old school. You look at those undersleeves that he's wearing. They're big and baggy. He's cut the wristbands off of them. A lot of the pitchers nowadays wear those Under Armour-type sleeves, skin tight. A little extra support to the muscles in the throwing arm.
The only thing that isn't old school is that look. Not quite Eric Gagne, but close. Swing and a miss on the curve.
Hey, Len, three more wins here in Milwaukee, and then it's Lollapalooza time, beginning Friday and continuing all weekend in Chicago's Grant Park, brought to you in part by Bud Light. It's our favorite 3 days of the year. Some of the headliners this year: Radiohead, Nine Inch Nails, Kanye West, Rage Against the Machine, Wilco, the Raconteurs, and dozens of other great acts. It's the Raconteurs you hear right there. For tickets, go to Lollapalooza.com. Lollapalooza and Bud Light keeps it coming.
And congratulations to DJ Matt Rome, son of WGN's Dan Rome. He'll be performing at Lollapalooza again. And Dan, with the sports coming up on the WGN News from here after the ball game. It's 1-0 Cubs.
Justice Room, wall to wall in teal.
Exactly.
And, you know, if you got a little extra carpet lying around, there might be a little something extra. Where are you?
Honey. I'll see what I have.
Hey, you're home early. What do you think?
Endless refreshment from start to finish. Bud Light keeps it coming.
Very easy, honey.
One moment we were feeling spontaneous.
Surprise, I'm home.
The next, we're happily interrupted. Hey, there's no problem for guys like me with ED. There's Cialis. Cialis is the only erectile dysfunction tablet clinically proven to both go to work fast in as little as 30 minutes for some men and work up to 36 hours. No other ED tablet can do both. Sure, Cialis can work fast, but having up to 36 hours is a great option. And working only when it should means I can respond to Deb only when we're ready. Tell your doctor about your medical condition and all medications, and ask if you're healthy enough for sexual activity. Don't take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain, as this may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Don't drink alcohol in excess with Cialis. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. To avoid long-term injury, seek immediate medical help if you experience an erection lasting more than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease in hearing or vision, stop taking Cialis and call your doctor right away. Why ask your doctor about Cialis? Because when the moment is right, you can be ready.
Is it mathematically possible that such a huge treat is just $2.49?
If I only had a brain.
The Peanut Buster Parfait from Dairy Queen. Creamy DQ soft serve, crunchy peanuts, and hot fudge for just $2.49.
WGN America, TV you can't ignore.
Our upcoming WGN-produced baseball schedule in high definition, sponsored by Comcast. Wednesday, the Sox are in Minnesota. Big battle in the AL Central. Game time 7 Central on WCIU, Channel 26. Cubs and Brewers from here on Thursday at 1 on WGN. And the series finale with the Pirates from Wrigley Field on Sunday at 1 for the leadoff man. One run to this point as we play the bottom of the fifth, and that was driven in by Mark DeRosa on a sacrifice fly in the fourth.
Giovanni Soto took one off the right shoulder right there. He wears that extension to cover the shoulder on his throwing arm, and that ball ripped right off of that protective pad.
The strike pitch to Cameron is too low. Shook him off a couple of times. Ooh, talk about getting in on the hands.
Oh, my. Get off me, ball. That was hit or be hit right there for Mike Cameron. That sinker just kept running further and further inside. It probably would hit him right in the chest if he didn't make contact.
The top of the ninth at Fenway, and right-hander John Lackey of the Angels has no hit the Red Sox through eight. He has walked one, struck out three. We'll keep you posted. Well, best wishes go out to Donna and Ron Hobick, formerly of Chicago. They now live in Florida. Happy wedding anniversary coming up this weekend. Also, Donna's birthday is on August 2nd. Huge Cubs fans. They watch whenever they can. Cameron can't keep hold of that bat.
Well, that first one, it ran up and in, and he fouled it off in self-defense. He's kind of flexing his right hand like may have gotten a stinger in there. And once again on this one, he just loses the bat completely.
Earlier today, the Angels acquired switch-hitting first baseman Mark Teixeira from the Braves. First baseman Casey Kochman and a minor league pitcher going the other way in that deal. Non-waiver deadline coming up here in a couple of days. We'll see some more deals, I'm sure. And we'll see more deals after August 1st as Cameron draws the walk. That was a painful plate appearance for Cameron, but it results in a leadoff walk. Hey, Cubs fans, we want to remind you that you can get official Cubs text and video alerts on your mobile phone. Text GET CUBS to 65246.
Now the Braves 7.5 out of first place in that National League East going into play today. But with Chipper Jones and Tim Hudson going on the disabled list, I think they felt their chances of getting back in that race legitimately were probably pretty slim.
And Teixeira's in the final year of his contract. Just about every deal that's made these days, although the Rich Harden deal would be an exception. He is not a free agent after the season, but when you see a deal like this one today, you go, oh, okay, he must be ready to leave after the season. That was a case for Sabathia in Cleveland. Slicing drive to right. DeRosa's going to get there and make the catch. He'll get it back in. Back the, maybe a faking a throw. Sure why he held on to it, but Cameron was able to get back.
DeRosa with those long strides covers a lot of ground out there in right field, chasing this one over toward the foul line.
He might not have had a good grip. That's maybe why he just held on.
Yeah, it looked like that ball was rattling around in the webbing of the glove a little bit there as he made the catch.
And Sheets went up the third base line to talk to Coach Dale Swain.
Now Sheets has put down five sacrifice bunts on the season, tying him for Jeff Suppan with the team lead.
Bautista swings away and pops it up. Terrio will get there. While we have a moment, let's step aside and see what's coming up on WGN.
WGN America, your home for summertime baseball. Keep your eyes here.
Len and Bob and our WGN sports crew on a big night here in Milwaukee. Cubs and Brewers, a battle for first this week, although after the Cubs won last night, they'll still be in sole possession when they wake up tomorrow either way. They have won their last two while Milwaukee has lost both after we had a first place tie going into action Sunday.
A snap throw to first by Carlos Zambrano. Rarely does he pay this much attention to the base runner because he gets rid of the ball so quickly to home plate, it's almost impossible to get a good jump against him.
I'll tell you, when Carlos has had to make a big pitch tonight, he's made it. All the base runners have been early on in these innings. They haven't put a man on after one out has been recorded. You see Durant protecting that front shin slash ankle area after fouling the ball off it.
It's a proverbial lock in the barn door after the horses have gotten away. No way to anticipate he was going to do that in his last at bat, but he's going to make sure not to do it again in this at bat.
Talking about guys fouling balls off their front leg, you think of former Cub Todd Hollinsworth, who fouled a couple of balls off that front shin. Did a lot of damage. 3-2 with two outs. Hardy on deck. Crowd's been fairly quiet because we haven't seen a ton of offense. Two starting pitchers have pretty much dominated.
I think it takes a little longer for fans to get into a pitching pool. They expect to see offense when they come to the ballpark, and usually it takes them a little deeper into the ballgame to appreciate a pitcher's duel.
Terrio again. They'll catch this pop up. And it's still 1-0 as we go to the sixth.
It's not a dream. You are not hallucinating. You're witnessing the metamorphosis of a new network. WGN America. Keep your eyes here. Becker, weeknights at 12:30 East, 9:30 West on WGN America.
Hey, we landed.
In the middle of the road.
Hop in, there's room.
There's one thing. We're in nudists.
Wow.
Ugh. Rear view camera. Ride ready. The new Pilot, only from Honda.
Bergman's Nature Valley. Lost Horse Creek, Bitterroot Range, Montana. Where's yours? 100% natural, whole grains, delicious. Nature Valley Granola Bars, the energy bar nature intended.
1-0 on Derek Lee. We're in the sixth. 7 hits and 1 run combined. Past Mike Quadi down at third. Ben Sheets, an all-star for the fourth time in his career. First round pick in 1999 out of Northeast Louisiana University. And Brannion can't get it. It squeaks past him into left. Derek's first hit in this ball game. As we check in on the Honda Accord game summary, visit your Honda dealer and test drive the all-new 268 horsepower Accord V6. Ramirez with a leadoff double in the fourth, scored on the DeRosa sack fly. Not much going for the Milwaukee offense. Aramis at the plate here for the third time. Nobody out. Aramis fouled that one off himself, but I think it hit the dirt first. John Lackey got within 2 outs of a no-no. He struck out Jacoby Ellsbury to start the bottom of the ninth, but then Dustin Pedroia with a single broke it up. The last 2 no-hitters in baseball have been thrown at Fenway Park, believe it or not. And now Kevin Youkilis with a 2-run homer. So the shutout has been broken as well.
Well, you see that happen so often when a pitcher carries a no-hitter deep into the ball game and gives up that first one. Usually there are more to follow shortly thereafter.
A little bit of a letdown. There's a drive deep to left field. Braun's going to give up on it. Off the wall. And Ramirez will have a double. Looked like Braun thought it was out. Aramis thought so too, but it just stayed in.
The ball hit like a bullet to left field. A low and inside fastball to Ramirez. He doesn't run initially. That ball hits about 3/4 of the way up the wall and straight away left field. We saw Soriano pose on a double last night. This time Ramirez posed momentarily and then turns it on and ends up at second base with a double.
They're in business, second and third, no outs. Now Braun knew it was over his head, but he was able to play the carom. He's going to lay out. Can't get it. Gets by him. Lee is in. Ramirez is going to score. Kosuke rounding third, rounding second, and on his way to third, and he's going to stop there with a triple. It's 3-0. Hit for Fukudome. Braun took a big chance, got caught in no man's land, and they've stretched the lead to 3.
Braun made a nice catch on Kosuke earlier in the ball game on a somewhat similar ball hit to left field. This time makes a diving attempt on that sinking line drive. Once it gets past him, nobody there to back up the play. see that ball slicing right at you as Braun makes that diving attempt. That's a bad feeling right there. Everybody in the ballpark's watching you jog out to the warning track after the baseball, and you know behind you there's a base runner streaking around those bases.
So that means DeRosa has to hit a home run. Single, double, triple to begin the inning. Field in.
He's had two good passes added his first two plate appearances in this game. It wouldn't surprise me a bit if he got the bat head out front on one.
Double play combo in about halfway. That's low, ball two. Third double of the season for Fukudome. We've seen positive signs lately from him at the plate. After battling through a slump. That's a base hit as Hardy slipped going after it. Kosuke is in. 4-0. Four straight hits.
Well, the fact that Ned Yost had his infield drawn in allows Mark DeRosa to slap that ball just past J.J. Hardy. As you mentioned, he spun his wheels a little bit. Right there, he lost his footing, couldn't get over there. Boy, normally Hardy has such great range at shortstop. You have to believe he might have been able to knock that one down had he not slipped.
You just keep the line moving. Lee with a single, Ramirez a double, Fukudome a two-run triple, and now DeRosa with an RBI hit. He's running as Fontenot will pick up a base hit. Braun trying to deke the run there. DeRosa, I'm sure, a huge sigh of relief that that ball got down. A bloop hit for Mike. They're all falling now.
That ball was in the air for an awfully long time for it to drop as deep as it did out there in left center field. Cameron started back initially on the ball. You saw Braun with that decoy attempt to try to make DeRosa think he was going to catch the ball, try to get Mark headed back to first base. A good base running on the part of DeRosa and some timely hitting on the part of Fontenot.
Still nobody out. Pitch number 91 from Sheets. Carlos Villanueva's up for the Brewers.
Carlos Zambrano shouting a few words of encouragement to Giovanni Soto before he digs back in for this 1-1 pitch. That time you clearly saw Jason Kendall wanted that pitch inside underneath the hands of Giovanni Soto, and Ben Sheets just has a lot of trouble throwing to that side of the plate to right-handed hitters.
Soto lines to left. Braun can't get it. They're going to hold him up. DeRosa at third. They are loaded. And the Cubs have made Ryan Braun run all over the outfield. Balls hit over him, past him, in front of him.
A nice quick swing by Giovanni Soto on a low fastball right here. Pow! Just drops ahead of the bat on a screaming line drive into left field. DeRosa had no choice but to hold up. That ball was hit so hard it looked like it might carry all the way out to Ryan Braun in left field.
Bases loaded for the pitcher Zambrano. Here we go. Single, double, triple, single, single, single. It's a thing of beauty. A bouncer to Hardy's going to throw, and it hits DeRosa. Everybody safe. to nothing. Bases still loaded with no outs. What an inning.
It's really the only play J.J. Hardy has. He could go across the diamond to first base and get Zambrano, but he tries to cut off the run at the plate. The angle that he was throwing that ball from, the sidearm toss hits DeRosa in the back of the left shoulder. Keep the line moving.
A single and an RBI. Another hit in the inning. Soriano takes ball one high. Ninth RBI of the year for Zambrano. He's allowed 11 hits, tying a season high.
Well, I'm really surprised at some point Mike Maddox, the pitching coach, or one of his teammates hasn't gone out to the mound just to break the rhythm a little bit. Try to take the air out of the Cubs' offense, but Ben Sheets just out there firing away.
Scored four. And they'd like to get a lot more here. A 1-2 to Soriano. High in the air. Cameron's drifting. This is going to be the first out. Everybody tagging. Z's going to go back to first. Fontenot scores. Soto to third. Sacrifice fly for Soriano. 6-0. And now Ned Yost coming out. And that'll be it for Ben Sheets. Five in, still only one out. It's now 6-0 Cubs, and we'll be right back.
Superstation WGN is now WGN America. It's not just TV, it's a lifestyle. So, quit your job, sell the car, and get ready to plant yourself in front of the team.
Do not quit your job or sell your car, and if you do, at least make sure you got a backup plan and or you get a good price for it. If you do plant yourself in front of the tube to watch the all-new WGN America, make sure you have plenty of snacks on hand because wild horses, fire, and or laser shooting flying saucers will be able to tear you away from the awesome stuff I just mentioned. For real, you've been warned.
WGN America, TV you can't ignore.
That's me, Dr. John Dorian. My friends call me JD.
Look what I confiscated from one of the kids in pediatrics.
Ow!
Not too hot?
Yeah! I'm an intern at a hospital that could use a little therapy.
They're doing a breast reduction on three, and I want to get up there and try and stop it.
In fact, sometimes things around here are so strange, they can make a TV show about it.
There's no beer.
Oh, we have a bit of beer.
Newsflash. You can't drink and then come to work. You're not airline pilots.
They could call it Scrubs.
I'm no Superman.
Nah, my job is right here.
Sorry, if that gets infected, I'm a doctor.
Saving lives at Sacred Heart.
Is anybody else a doctor? What's going on down there?
Scrubs, 7 nights a week at 11 East, 8 West.
While we take a quick breath, here's another look at tonight's AT&T text poll question. Last chance to vote for your least favorite team from Wisconsin. And while you think about that, step aside for a moment, see what's coming up on WGN.
Plan your laugh attack where the comedies are whack. WGN America, your home for comedy. Friday nights, starting at 11 East, 8 West.
A reminder, the WGN News follows the game, including sports with Dan Rohn here from Milwaukee. Carlos Villanueva is on, trying to stop the bleeding for the Brewers. Cubs have hit some balls very hard in this inning. The bloops have dropped in two. First and third, a 1-0 pitch to Terrio is outside. You have Soto over at third. Zambrano is at first. Both with singles in the inning. hit foul. This is that inning we've been waiting to see from the Cubs, particularly on the road.
Get everybody involved in the offense. Started at the three spot. We've rolled around to the leadoff spot in the lineup with only one out in the inning.
Slicing flies out of play off to the right.
Well, I'm a little surprised that the Brewers are holding Carlos Zambrano on first base, knowing full well that Ryan Terrio likes to shoot that ball to right field. They're giving him a huge hole on that right side. Carlos doesn't figure to be going anywhere with a 6-0 lead here in the fifth inning. I want him to save all of his energy for that bump out there in the middle of the infield.
The second out, Terrio fans. Derek Lee, who started the inning with a single, will come up again. Villanueva has pitched well lately. He's given up one earned run over his last 11 and a third innings. Began the year in the starting rotation, but struggled. Had a 6.43 ERA over nine starts. He's been much better in relief. A 2.05. Explain it, but the Cubs love it. Only one run against Sheets over the first five and couldn't get anybody out in the sixth. The one out he got was on a warning track fly. This one's deep to straightaway center. Cameron's back on a warning track. He's going to leap and he gets it, robbing Derek of extra bases. A three-time Gold Glover, Mike Cameron, ending the inning with this catch. But a huge inning for the Cubs. They played five and lead 6-0.
WGN America, your summertime home for baseball.
eHarmony asked a lot of questions in the questionnaire.
My partner's energy level, I mark that as very important to me.
And one of the ones in particular that I found interesting was finding pleasure and contentment in simple things.
Are you romantic? Are you stubborn? Are you shy? Vivacious, rational, trusting?
How far are you willing to search?
It was the first time anyone asked me that, though, whether I was self-aware.
With our in-depth questionnaire, we get to know the real you, so we can match you with other singles based on compatibility. Log on today and review your matches for free. eHarmony.com.
What my life is like and managing my diabetes is very complicated.
Simplify your life with a free Breeze 2 meter and a free 10 test disc from Bayer. Call 1-800-582-3131 or visit breezemeter.com.
You're twisting and turning a lot as to what should I do first. I need to talk to this client, but I'm feeling a little dizzy. I think I better check my blood sugar. So it's that kind of back and forth that feels like a tornado sometimes. I fell in love with the 10 test disc. The Breeze 2 is the best. It helps me with everything else in the day to just fall in line.
Only the Breeze 2 meter from Bayer comes with a unique, easy-to-use disc, so you only load strips every 10 tests, and you never have to code your meter to make testing simple.
I'm Suzanne Lipinski, and finding balance is my simple win.
Get your free Breeze 2 meter with a free 10 test disc. Call today, 1-800-582-3131, or visit breezemeter.com.
At Sacred Heart Hospital, our doctors are among the best in the nation.
Scrubs live seven nights a week at 11 East, 8 West.
Bunch of big hits in that sixth inning. The biggest, the two-run triple by Kosuke Fukudome. So Z back out there, and he pitched in with an RBI infield hit of his own. Can never have too much against this home run hitting offense. Way up in the air to shallow center. And it's Kosuke. Visit the official online shop of the Chicago Cubs at Cubs.com. Browse the largest selection of authentic team gear, including clubhouse caps and t-shirts, jerseys, collectibles, and more. Get your team gear straight from the source. Check out the Cubs.com shop today. Brawny's Bayou.
Okay.
Well represented.
There you go.
High for ball one.
Ryan Braun was born in Mission Hills, California, lives in Granada Hills. I don't know if they have a bayou there, but whatever.
But, Miami? Z is 3-1 in four starts since coming off the disabled list. He threw 125 pitches, second most of the season in his last outing. A little bit off the plate, 2-2. Pitch count in fine shape tonight. Strike three to get Braun. Time to see how you voted on tonight's AT&T text poll question. Yeah, the Packers taking almost two-thirds of the votes. And the Brewers on that list. Second, and then the Golden Eagles. That's a little shot at me, to be honest with you. That's okay. I can take it. Strike on Prince Fielder. I know we have a lot of DePaul alums who watch, so I'm sure they're voting for Marquette on that list. Maybe some Notre Dame fans. Notice how quiet it is in here.
Mm-hmm. You know, the Cub fans are exhausted from cheering for that top half of the sixth inning, and the Brewers fans have had very little to cheer about in this game, period.
Hit hard on the ground between Fontenot and Lee. The fielder keeps the Brewers alive for Corey Hart. Dempster tomorrow night against left-hander Manny Parra. Another terrific matchup. Cardinals with a run in the eighth. They now lead at Atlanta 3-2. Terrio goes to Fontenot, second inning over. Nice shutdown inning from Z. It's 6-0 to the seventh.
Chicago Cubs baseball is brought to you by Pepsi. Every sip gets you closer.
Every sip gets you closer to Justin Timberlake MP3s.
Hey, I like it.
KDU. HDTVs, millions of songs from Amazon MP3 and more. Sign up at PepsiStuff.com.
Get Pepsi Stuff points on specially marked Pepsi or Diet Pepsi 24-ounce six-packs for a free Amazon MP3 music download.
They say a man should always dress for the job he wants. So why am I dressed up like a pirate in this restaurant? It's all because some hacker stole my identity. Now I'm in here every evening serving chowder and iced tea. Should have gone to freecreditreport.com. I could have seen this coming at me like an atom bomb. They monitor your credit and send you email alerts, so you don't end up selling fish to tourists in t-shirts.
Offer applies with enrollment and Triple Advantage.
Alex Klein is a real GEICO customer, not a paid celebrity. So to help tell his story, we hired that guy who does those funny sound effects.
My car was totaled over 1,000 miles from home. So I called GEICO. And in less than 10 business hours, I got a check for a new car.
GEICO. Real service, real savings.
Ray Durham is out, and Craig Counsell is in. Found that ball off his shin earlier. Ramirez cranks it to deep left, twisting and turning his brawn. That one over his head. Aramis on his way to second base again. That's his third double tonight.
Just another bullet off the bat of Aramis Ramirez. Starting to get locked in up there at the plate. This one, as you mentioned, turned Ryan Braun completely around on his trip back to the warning track. Bounces off that out-of-town scoreboard. An easy double for Aramis.
Kosuke batting. Council will have to throw to first with Aramis now at third. Well, the top two starters for Milwaukee have been pitching so well. 13 earned runs over the previous four starts combined. And 9 already in this series.
You know, Len, sometimes I think we can get a little too caught up in sending messages and psychological edges, but it really has to rattle the Brewers' cage a little bit to send their two big boys to the mound in the first two games of this series and have the Cubs' offense bang them around the way they did. Now, granted, Sabathia pitched very well last night, but not up to his own standards. And Sheets was pretty strong until the sixth, and then the wheels came off for him. But if you're the Brewers and have been playing behind those two guys recently, you got to wonder what's going on.
Gobbled up by Hardy with Aramis holding. DeRosa's retired. Well, it's been said, and I think we both agree, that nothing is going to be determined in this four-game series. But you gave the spread. I mean, going into last night, the Cubs could be as many as 5 up when we leave Thursday. They could have been as many as 3 down. That range has now changed after last night. But a chance to get back to 3 ahead if they can hold on here late. Wouldn't mind adding on after Aramis doubled to start the inning. Now there are 2 outs and a 1-0 count on Mike Fontenot. Backs up fielder. He's able to get it. Villanueva covering the bag. Middle of the seventh. They'll get up and stretch. 6 zip Cubs.
It's not a dream. You are not hallucinating. You're witnessing the metamorphosis of a new network. WGN America. Keep your eyes here.
WGN America. TV you can't ignore.
Hi. Oh, hey, you guys.
Thanks for coming. I love how you decorated.
Yeah, the garden gnomes are really great. The garden gnomes.
Refreshment from start to finish. Bud Light keeps it coming.
It's not what you're thinking.
Huh.
I get a little help here? Hello. Hey. We all upgraded to Verizon Wireless. Got push to talk and the reliability of the network. That old service is useless now. Careful. Cement.
Don't be the last one standing with another push to talk. Switch to the only one that comes with the network. Get these great deals when you activate push to talk on 5 business lines. Verizon Wireless.
Family tradition.
What's that?
The one where we pass our plates to the right.
When did that become a family tradition?
When you ordered that.
Try Olive Garden's new grilled garlic shrimp. Marinated shrimp topped with a roasted garlic glaze. Or try new grilled balsamic glazed chicken. Both served over angel hair pasta and homemade cream sauce. Two new grilled dishes with endless salad and breadsticks.
I think I like this new family tradition.
Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
I think going into this series, we thought this would be the best of the four matchups, as good as several of those others are. But Ben Sheets got knocked around big time. Z has held up his end of the bargain on both sides, on the mound and at the plate.
Well, not only has he put zeros up there, but he's managed to do it in a very economical way tonight. Pitch count is always somewhat of a concern with Carlos, even though he declared himself 100% ready to go, no problems. Did mention he threw 125 last time out, and he's made the most of every...
So Brannion retired. He's 0 for 3. Well, again, Dempster and Parra tomorrow night, and we'll have game 4 on Thursday afternoon. Rich Harden still trying to find that first win. 30 strikeouts, 10 in each of his first 3 starts. This will be his first career start against the Brewers. Dave Busch struggled in his last outing, as Milwaukee is going with the home road platoon, with Busch pitching at home and Seth McClung taking those starts on the road. Well, Mike Cameron, that Gold Glover in center, who made a big catch to end the sixth after the Cubs had already scored 5 times. Don't know what a Gold Glover in left, how he would have affected that inning, but it's been a long night for Ryan Braun, who has not committed an error all season. But when it comes to outfield play, that's not indicative of how strong a season you're having defensively. He is new to that position. He played third last season and really struggled.
I'm sure with more playing time and reading more balls off the bat in game situations, Ryan Braun will improve, because he's a very hard worker out there on his defense. Every day he comes out early to go through defensive drills, taking balls off the fungo bat and then taking balls off the BP bats. But very much a learning process right now for Ryan Braun in left field. And you bring up a great point about the errors for the outfielders. If a guy gets a bad jump on the ball or takes a bad line to where the ball is coming down, he may not touch it. He may not be credited with an error. But managers and coaches and other players know that good outfielders take the quickest line directly to where the ball is going to come down. They get good jumps off the bat. And that all comes with more experience, or maybe it won't. We'll see.
I mean, you'd rather not make any errors, but even if you don't, there are balls you don't get to that end up becoming doubles or triples or singles. Like, statistically, defense has always been the trickiest area to quantify. Broken bat floater, that'll be a base hit for Cameron.
Well, and as always, it's time to have a ball with our friends at the Illinois Lottery. And when you're at Miller Park, you gotta watch the Cased Meat Races.
They're holding steady as they pass the Cubs on the inside chorizo, on the outside hot dog, trying to make a move. Polish around home plate into the home stretch. Who's gonna take this one? It's gonna be close between hot dog and chorizo. Hey, I think hot dog's got the move.
Okay?
We're trapped, and there's seven of us. There's no way we'll fit in there.
There's room for eight.
Oh, forget it. We have too many beverages.
There's like 12 cup holders in here.
But what about this bison?
That thing got my blood a-boiling.
Well, it's probably just the seat warmer.
Seating for eight. Ride ready. The new Pilot, only from Honda.
Available representative will be with you in 4 hours, 10 minutes.
Get your identity stolen, you'll spend day after day on the phone getting it back. With calls to the bank, credit cards, the Social Security office, and on it goes.
Please continue to hold.
Fortunately, there's Farmers Identity Shield. For just $65 or less per year, your credit is monitored.
Thank you for holding.
Plus, a personal fraud advocate helps make all those calls no matter how long it takes. So make only one now. 1-800-FARMERS.
Is it mathematically possible that such a huge treat is just $2.49?
If I only had a brain.
The Peanut Buster Parfait from Dairy Queen. Creamy DQ soft serve, crunchy peanuts, and hot fudge for just $2.49.
Remember when TV was good, decent, and wholesome? Remember when sitcoms had integrity?
All right, get up!
And a good moral message?
Wow! Look what I'm doing with teenage boys!
We're bringing it all back.
You wanna go to the moon? Do you wanna go to the moon?
You don't have to be classy.
I'm Larry. This is my brother Daryl. That's my other brother Daryl.
To be classic. Sunday night is Out of Sight Retro Night on WGN America. Keep your eyes here. Scrubs lives 7 nights a week at 11 East, 8 West on WGN America.
On his car when he leaves. 6-0. Cubs won last night, 6-4. How about the breaking?
Game. when you least expect it. He floats that Ephus breaking ball up there. Weeks just couldn't lay off.
Guillermo Mota with an inflated 535 earned run average. Third pitcher tonight for Milwaukee. Cardinals now lead at Atlanta 5-2 in the ninth. Go-ahead run scored. Albert Pujols stole third and scored on a throwing error by catcher Corky Miller. Earlier, Pujols hit a home run, his 21st. So tied the game with the homer and took the lead with his base running. It's now 6-2. He scored three in the ninth. Still a little early to look at the wild card, but Milwaukee looking up at the Cubs, and they might be looking over their shoulder at the Cardinals here at some point. It could be just a game up after tonight.
Furious battle for fourth place in the Central Division as well. The Reds and the Astros both 12 and a half back going into play tonight. The Pirates 13 back.
We'll see the Pirates coming up on Friday at Wrigley Field. They beat the Rockies 6-4. So they've won two straight. Cool off the Rockies a bit. Ryan Dempster starting tomorrow night. Pirates put Adam LaRoche on the DL with a back injury today.
So the Pirates will come into town over the weekend with no Adam LaRoche. Xavier Nady's been traded.
Thomas Omarte in that deal. We've been picking up some save chances with Matt Capps on the shelf. Actually, they're calling the LaRoche injury a strained muscle in his rib cage. I read previous reports it was his back. It's all connected. Soto swings and misses and strikes out. Here comes Big Z for his fourth at bat.
The pitcher, Carlos Zambrano.
So the Cubs fans on their feet. Beebe was on his feet doing a little MC Hammer there.
Yeah. This is what you'd call a partial standing ovation. Well, he certainly deserves it tonight. He's been the workhorse. Gone out there and done exactly what his team needed him to do tonight.
He's 1-for-3 and his batting average has gone down a point. It's a 355.
And he's trying to make up for that with one swing. You know, then we get these pitcher-batter matchup sheets for both teams when we go into a series. They're going to have to start including Zambrano on these sheets. They never put the pitchers on there.
You'd have to put the Zambrano numbers on sheets and against sheets. Should update that game at Boston. It's a final 6-2. John Lackey did complete it. Two down.
Time for tonight's Bud Light fan cam as the Cub fans unite in Milwaukee. Switchfoot with We Are One Tonight. Great track by the band Switchfoot from their 2006 release, Nothing Is Sound. That's tonight's Bud Light fan cam. Bud Light keeps it coming.
Soriano bounces it past Mota, but not by Hardy, who will get him. A little more Switchfoot as we go to break. All Cubs in game two. They lead 6-0 as we head to the bottom of the eighth.
Sacred Heart Hospital, our doctors are among the best in the nation.
Is anybody else a doctor?
Scrubs, 7 nights a week at 11 East, 8 West on WGN America. Brought to you in part by Vagisil, 100% woman, 100% of the time.
Power, performance, and gas mileage with Crestone Fuel System Cleaner and save up to $396 on the deal. Whatever you're working on, Advance will help you keep the wheels turning.
The generation that swore it would never get old didn't. Welcome to the Summer of Life. And now there's an official hair treatment of the Summer of Your Life. New Touch of Gray from Just for Men. Let you keep a little gray. Works gradually. Just comb in, rinse.
Never trust anybody over 90.
Keep a little gray with New Touch of Gray.
Tires with Unity technology, only from Firestone.
Wow, looks like we're in Los Angeles. And headed for the exits. We saw a lot of people leaving late last night, and they missed a bizarre finish. As Craig Counsell will bat for the first time in the series. If Craig went to Notre Dame, he would have voted for Marquette, for his least favorite Wisconsin team, probably. Even though he's from here, the 0-1 to him is pulled foul. And we thought the game was over as Carlos Marmol appeared to strike out Gabe Kapler. And the Cubs came onto the field. I said, Cubs win. When the umpires got together and realized it was a foul ball that hit the dirt, then Kapler fly to deep left. Missed a home run by maybe 10 feet. That would have tied the game.
That was a very awkward-looking swing from Kapler, very reminiscent of the swing that Kirk Gibson took in the 88 World Series when he hit the home run off Dennis Eckersley. Just kind of one-handed it out to the warning track in left field, but Soriano had enough room to run it down, as does Ryan Terrio on that soft floater off the bat of Counsell.
So you're saying it was a kind of swing maybe Gabe Kaplan would have taken? As opposed to Gabe Kapler. That's all I think of every time I hear the name Gabe Kapler. Strike one on Hardy. The 108th offering of the night. Still nobody up in the pen. This is Z's game for the time being.
I don't know if you noticed that. Carlos Zambrano took a look at his throwing hand. Looked like the fingertips of his throwing hand. Maybe the beginning of a hot spot there or something. First time I've seen him do that in this start tonight. Sometimes it's a cumulative thing. You've thrown so many pitches that you start to develop the beginnings of a little bit of a blister. Other times it's just one pitch where the ball comes off your fingertip funny. But notice Carlos just took a quick peek at his fingers before climbing right back up on the mound.
Kerry Wood still on the disabled list. He was eligible to come off tonight. Still hasn't been able to throw all of his pitches comfortably without some sort of protection on the right index finger. Two, fouled back by Hardy.
That's funny, Len. I was down in Lou's office with Ron Sando and Corey Provis and some of the other guys earlier today, and Larry Rothschild walked by the office, and Lou called him in. And it's something that happens every day. He wanted to know the status of the guys in the bullpen. Who do we need to stay away from today? Who can we use, and how much can we use them? And Larry said, well, I'd just like to see Carlos go out and go nine. Give the whole bullpen a night off, and Carlos is making an effort to do that.
Called strike three. It's nine tonight.
Time for our AM, PM, too much good stuff, no doubt about it. Carlos Zambrano had too much good stuff for the Brewers hitters so far in this ballgame tonight. Has overpowered him with his fastball at times, has finessed him with his breaking ball at times, even broke out the Eefus pitch to strike out Ricky Weeks. Too much good stuff, Carlos Zambrano. Thank you, AM, PM.
No runs allowed. Last time he completed eight was a 5-1 win against the Reds on the 9th of July. One hit, one run. No complete games this year. I'm guessing this is his last inning, especially with a team up six.
That ought to be an interesting conversation in the dugout between Luke Pinella and Carlos Zambrano, though, to try to convince him to come out of the game. Looks like Jeff Samardzija beginning to crank it up down the Cubs bullpen.
I saw an interesting piece. I think it was Joe Sheehan in Baseball Prospectus talking about pitch counts, and he kind of laid out an argument that you don't want to go too far with it, especially with guys who've been in the big leagues for a while and who are older than the age of 25. I mean, a guy like Z, he can throw more pitches than a lot of guys. Up, getting close to 120, but he looks so strong tonight. Through eight, has not allowed a run. It's 6-0 Cubs.
WGN America, your summertime home for baseball.
Perfect beer deserves the perfect pour. Right down the middle, releasing all the flavor. Perfect.
Well, call me a perfectionist.
Well, I married my dream girl. I married my dream girl, but she didn't tell me her credit was bad. So now, instead of living in a pleasant suburb, we're living in the basement at her mom and dad's. No, we can't get a loan for a respectable home just because my girl defaulted on some old credit card. If we'd gone to freecreditreport.com, I'd be a happy bachelor with a dog and a yard.
Offer applies with enrollment and triple advantage.
Here's a tip. Order a Budweiser on draft. It's kept cold from the brewery to the distributor to the tap. Can't get a more refreshing Budweiser than that.
I thought I was supposed to tip you.
He still can.
Oh, hey, I'm the night watchman here at the Fortress of Television Innovation. My job takes me from the top to the very bottom of this mighty structure. It's up to me to keep the fortress safe and secure from mediocre television. So one day, I discovered a vault filled with movies and created myself a secret getaway. I call it the Movie Underground.
Enter the Movie Underground Friday night at 85 West right here on WGN America. Becker, tonight at 12:30 East, 9:30 West, on WGN America. Keep your eyes here.
Ed Yost and Dana DeMuth, the home plate umpire, having a rather involved conversation between innings.
Yeah, that started out fairly heated, but cooled off quickly, and at the end it looked just like a very calm conversation between the Brewers skipper and the home plate umpire. Not sure exactly what precipitated that conference, but we saw him down there between innings.
We're in the ninth, 6-0 Cubs. Moda went 1-2-3 in the eighth, facing Terrio, Liam Ramirez. The next pitch. Into right center and a base hit. Past Corey Hart. And Terrio's going to make the turn and head to third. And he'll get there with a triple. Maybe we had a weird angle on it, but I thought Corey Hart was easily able to get to that ball, and all of a sudden it shot past him. Second triple tonight for the Cubs, is second on the year for Terrio.
A lot of side spin on that ball hit into the gap in right center. This gets back to the conversation we had an inning ago about errors in the outfield. This will not be counted as an error, but certainly a ball that Corey Hart should have gotten to and cut off. Fastball middle of the plate, just sliced into the gap in right center field. Looked like Terrio was going to be content with a single. Then he said, wait a minute, I can get two. Geez, that rolled all the way to the wall. I can get three.
One and oh on D. Lee. 13 hits for the Cubs. Ball two. Zambrano with 118 pitches. Samardz is throwing in the pen. Looks like Jeff will probably try to finish it up. Yeah, the Joshian piece in Baseball Prospectus, he was basically saying that he thinks at times starting pitchers are babied a bit too much. And his numbers are 25-120. He said once a pitcher is 25, you could consider him physically mature enough to handle a full workload. Carlos Zambrano's now 27 and is used to throwing more pitches than most starting pitchers. Now, you do have to be cautious because of the shoulder issue earlier this year, but he's come back looking better than ever. Terrio's going to hold as it's backhanded by Hardy. And as you say all the time, it's not always the number. Z didn't have a ton of trouble. The Brewers never did get a runner past second base.
I think it still is a very subjective thing. Certain guys are capable of handling more of a workload. As you mentioned, certain games are a lot more stressful. Certain innings are more stressful within a game. You just have to really rely on your eyes and your experience as a manager and as a pitching coach. You have to know your staff, each individual guy, and what their limits are, and the nonverbal things to look for when a guy's getting near the end of his rope.
And notice how much more cautious the Cubs have been with Rich Harden because of all the injury problems he's had, as opposed to Carlos. Just gets past Kendall, but not far enough for Terrio to score. The Cubs want to make sure Rich Harden is as close to fully healthy as possible right at the end of the season. He was brought in to help take this team into October. Yes, it's been a good problem. He's had so many strikeouts, the pitch count's built up so early.
And that's been one of Carlos Zambrano's, I mean, if you want to call it a problem in the past, was the fact he struck out so many batters that his pitch count was always elevated early in the ballgame. But he has been a much more efficient pitcher this year. His strikeout totals are way down, but the results are way up.
The left, base hit. Terrio can jog home. 7-0. That's the fourth straight hit for Aramis. That'll bring out Ned Yost. probably see Brian Schaus against Kosuke. So he'll take the baseball from Moda, 7-0 here in the ninth.
Is it real? Well, some say there are two of them, each 1,000 feet long. Once a year, they come out for 4 days and 3 nights. Is it real? I hope so.
Oh, it's real. The Bud Light Party Cruise. Two ships, one legendary time. Arr.
That's me, Dr. John Dorian. My friends call me JD.
Look what I confiscated from one of the kids in pediatrics.
Ow!
What, too hot?
Yeah! I'm an intern at a hospital that could use a little therapy.
They're doing a breast reduction on three, and I want to get up there and try and stop it.
In fact, sometimes things around here are so strange, they can make a TV show about it.
There's no beer.
We had a beer.
Newsflash, you can't drink and then come to work. You're not airline pilots.
They could call it Scrubs.
Hello, Superman.
Nah, my job is right here.
Sorry, if that gets infected, I'm a doctor.
Saving lives at Sacred Heart.
Is anybody else a doctor?
What's going on down there?
Scrubs, 7 nights a week at 11 East, 8 West.
Tonight for the Cubs, but as we check out the Nissan drive of the game, it was a well-placed triple by Kosuke Fukudome in the sixth inning, part of that five-run inning. Got by Braun, 2 runs scored, and that's tonight's Nissan drive of the game.
Kosuke will now have to face his lone left-hander in Nedio's bullpen, Brian Schaus. He is a very definition of a left-handed specialist. He's held lefties to a 162 average in 68 at-bats against left-handed hitters. 20 strikeouts, no walks.
All right, first, a run in. Slings it up there, ball one. 45,069, the paid crowd. It has thinned a little bit over the past couple of innings, with the Cubs leading now by 7. Some heading west. Some heading south, possibly. Chicago, although most Cub fans, they want to stay until the final out is recorded. Can't get away from the highway construction.
Orange barrels everywhere. I think they grow them up here. There's a field somewhere that they grow those orange barrels.
Well, the big interchange here, they call the Marquette Interchange. That's why everybody voted against Marquette tonight.
Yeah, that's it.
Traffic. Another gapper. This one's going to roll all the way out to the warning track. Picked up by Cameron. And Kosuke with a couple of extra base hits. 2 for 5 with a 2-run triple and now a double. Bringing up DeRosa with runners at second and third. Still only one out.
Well, good to see Kosuke getting it going a little bit again. Starting to hit some line drives. Finds the gap in right center this time. Different circumstances. Closer ball game. You may have seen Mike Quadi wave Aramis Ramirez on home, but not taking any chances with a 7-0 lead here in the top of the ninth.
Strike one on DeRosa. He's knocked in two. In fact, he could get the game-winning RBI sac fly in the fourth, first run of the night. Scalded foul. A ruled foul. Well, congratulations to Ichiro tonight, picking up his 3,000th hit, if you combine his time in Japan and now in the major leagues. Kosuke is one home run away from 200. If you combine his numbers with Chunichi and the Cubs.
And that would have been the 130th hit of the season for Ichiro. Ranked third in the American League going into play tonight.
1,722 of those hits coming with the Mariners. He's only been in the majors since 2001. Swing and a miss. So DeRosa strikes out. And we'll be up to Fontenot with two gone. Wild game. Seattle's involved in it. Texas, they trail 9-8 in the seventh. It's a final in Atlanta. And the Cardinals beat the Braves 8-3.
I think back to spring training and the early part of this season, Len, with the leadoff hitter controversy with the Cubs and Alfonso Soriano. Is he really a leadoff hitter? I heard the same argument for Ichiro out in Seattle many, many times in spring training, because he rarely takes a base on balls. But the guy gets 240, 250 hits a year. Hits in the high 350s, 360 every year, steals bases. Yeah, granted, he may not be the prototypical leadoff hitter, but he's a pretty darn good
one. Yeah, you're right. Ichiro's career average, .330, is on base percentage, .377. And Fonzie will strike out a lot more, but he'll also hit a lot more home runs.
And hopefully with his legs at 100%, as we've seen tonight, he's running much more aggressively on the bases. We'll see those stolen base totals start to climb here in the second half of the season.
A little bit away on a breaker. And it's 2-2. Chouse's 2-2 pitch runs in. Full count. Soto on deck. Jeff Samardzija is still up in the Cubs pen. Likely to pitch the bottom of the ninth. Throwing a complete game out there.
And he's shutting them out in the pen.
You mentioned the other day how he warms up behind the mound. There's not a lot of room behind that mound out in the bullpen. Foul tip, strikeout. Three hits and a run in the ninth. 15 hits on the night for the Cubs. They lead by a touchdown with a former Notre Dame football star coming in.
Is Dave Chappelle really? He's Rick James, Lil Jon, Blackzilla, a Black Klansman, a Milkman, Tron Carter, Silky Johnson, Gallagher, Prince.
Here's a celebration.
Chappelle's Show, Friday night at midnight East, 9 West, on WGN America. Every sip gets you closer to Justin Timberlake MP3s.
Hey.
Katie, you. HDTVs, millions of songs from Amazon MP3, and more. Sign up at PepsiStuff.com.
Get Pepsi Stuff points on specially marked Pepsi or Diet Pepsi 24-ounce six-packs for a free Amazon MP3 music download.
You're so funny.
You know, I love our family tradition.
What's that?
The one where we pass our plates to the right.
When did that become a family tradition?
When you ordered that.
Oh,
try I
Olive Garden's new grilled garlic shrimp. Marinated shrimp topped with a roasted garlic glaze. Or try new grilled balsamic glazed chicken. Both served over angel hair pasta and homemade cream sauce. Two new grilled dishes with endless salad and breadsticks.
I think I like this new family tradition.
Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
Take me out to insurance. Take me to Savings Online. Auto insurance that's hassle-free. When you buy it instantly, let me quote Father Dad Insurance. If you don't pay, it's a shame. For it's $100 you can save with the insurance name.
Save time and money on your auto insurance at Esurance.
Well, as good as Jeff Samardzija's stuff was on Friday, he looked like a much more comfortable Major League pitcher on Sunday. And I guess in honor of Goose Gossage, who was inducted into the Hall of Fame, he picked up a two-inning save. Got that game ball from Jim Edmonds.
Yeah, showed much better off-speed stuff. His second time around, a couple of real good split-finger fastballs for strikeouts, and still had that good pop on the high 90s fastball.
It was his first pro save. He had one at Notre Dame. He starts Fielder off with a strike. A split for strike two. Maybe too early to tell, but I've seen the comparisons thrown out there. Maybe he's the new Frankie Rodriguez or Jabba Chamberlain. If he continues to do what he's done, it's almost like the Cubs made a deal. He strikes out Fielder, one out.
Well, you need a lot of things to go well if you're going to have a successful season and get deep into the postseason. You need your established players to do what you expect them to do, and you need a couple guys to surprise. And Jeff Samardzija well on his way to being one of those surprise players in the second half of the season.
Ball one on Corey Hart. Just a little bit of a leap to get it. Two outs.
Sound like Hart hit that ball a little bit off the end of the bat. That gave Ramirez just enough time to shuffle a couple of steps to his left and jump. Make a nice catch. You see Ryan Terrio trying to help out at shortstop. He was jumping right along with Rami.
Russell Branyan fouls off. Samardzija's 0-1. Outside, a ball and a strike. Jeff had some struggles at Double A. Really concentrated on first pitch strikes when he went up to AAA and now in the majors, being aggressive early in the count. Is 1-1. Now 2-1. Kick and the pitch, 3-1. Cameron on deck. He'll only get a chance if Branyan reaches. The Brewers have put a total of two runners in scoring position all night. Branyan walks. The producer of Cubs Baseball on WGN Sports is Pete Thomas. Skip Ellison is our director. Our associate producer, Mark Brady. The executive producer of WGN Sports, Bob Vorwald. Thanks as well to our stage manager in the booth, Vince Lupo. Our production assistant, Ben Hutchinson, who made the trip up here to Milwaukee with us. Our studio coordinator back at WGN, Christina Ballas. And our entire WGN crew here in Brewtown. Cubs trying to make it two in a row to start this series and three straight overall. And good trip to the mound for Soto.
Just slow Jeff Samardzija down a little bit here. Got two quick outs in the inning. Sniffing the barn a little bit. Just tried to overthrow to Russell Brandon. Lost him to the base on balls. Finish on a good note here.
Camera taps it foul. Rough night for Ben Sheets. He's been at that top step, however, just about the entire time since he came out. Brandon goes again. And that one's going to go to the wall. Break the shutout as Brandon coming around third toward the plate, and he's going to score at 7-1. Cameron with an RBI double.
About hitters that keyhole against certain pitchers, and with Samardzija struggling to find the strike zone against Mike Cameron, he was just looking for a fastball somewhere in the middle of the plate. He got it and didn't miss it.
The 0-1 to Kendall. Ramirez is going to charge. To Lee, Cubs win. Samardzija gives up a run in the ninth, but the Cubs with a comfortable 7-1 victory. And the lead's now up to 3 in the division with 2 to go in this series. Update the standings. Again, the Cardinals won. Cubs have kept them 4 back. Milwaukee now 3 out. So the Cubs now 63-44 on the year. Still 6 games under on the road, but an excellent start to this quick 4-game trip. Couldn't have gone much better tonight if you had written out the script.
Pitchers duel through 5 innings. Both aces doing their thing out there on the mound. The Cubs broke through first in the fourth, actually, with the sack fly from Mark DeRosa. But then that fateful 6th inning when the Cubs offense exploded for 5 runs on 7 hits. Yeah, this is exactly what Lou was hoping for in the first 2 games of this series.
Dan Rome down on the field with a guy who had 4 hits tonight.
All right, Lenny, thanks very much. Aramis Ramirez, 4 hits tonight, 3 doubles against the Brewers ace, Ben Sheets. And you guys dominated start to finish in this one.
Well, we played a good ball game. I mean, Zambrano pitched great. Timely hitting. We got the big inning and the 8-6 inning, I think. So anytime you score that many runs of a pitcher like that, you got a pretty good chance to win the ball game.
I think it was 11 hits and 5 1/3 innings. You guys roughed them up pretty good. Have you ever hit any balls as hard as that and not had them go out of the park?
Actually, yeah. You know, I hit it on the line. For you to hit a homer, you gotta elevate it a little bit. But I take it. You know, I guess Ben Sheet is one of the best in the game. So any hit you get off that guy like that, you gotta take it.
Pretty good statement made by the Cubs in the first 2 games here. You beat Sabathia on Monday and Sheets tonight.
Well, we still got two more guys to go. I mean, we played great yesterday. We played great today. Can't take anything for granted. We got two more games. We got to come back with the same energy and try to win both of them.
Okay, Rami, thanks. Appreciate it. Good game. Nice job tonight. Ramos Ramirez, you guys, four hits as the Cubs pound out 15 and dominate the Brewers here at Miller Park.
Thanks, Dan. It was a huge night for Aramis and company. 15 hits. They scored 7 runs, 13 in the first 2 games. The offense is back. We'll be back from Milwaukee in a moment.
Next on WGN, the West Coast rattled, shaken by a powerful earthquake, followed by 36 aftershocks. Pub patrons are out of luck. A popular chain shuts the doors to dozens of restaurants without warning. And we're live in Milwaukee with a reaction to Game 2 of the Cubs' big series with the Brewers.
That ball slicing right at you as Braun makes that dive.
Perfect beer deserves the perfect pour. Right down the middle, releasing all the flavor.
Call me a perfectionist.
Everybody knows that nothing puts a damper on the right moment like an interruption. The good news is it could wait till later. Because for guys like me with ED, there's Cialis. Cialis is the only erectile dysfunction tablet clinically proven to both go to work fast in as little as 30 minutes for some men and work up to 36 hours. No other ED tablet can do both. Work fast or give us the option of having up to 36 hours to get back to what got interrupted. And Cialis works so that I can respond to Sally only when we're ready. Tell your doctor about your medical condition and all medications and ask if you're healthy enough for sexual activity. Don't take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain, as this may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Don't drink alcohol in excess with Cialis. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. To avoid long-term injury, seek immediate medical help if you experience an erection lasting more than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease in hearing or vision, stop taking Cialis and call your doctor right away. Why ask your doctor about Cialis? Because when the moment is right, you can be ready.
The next available representative will be with you in 4 hours, 10 minutes.
Get your identity stolen? You'll spend day after day on the phone getting it back. With calls to the bank, credit cards, the Social Security office, and on it goes.
Please continue to hold.
Fortunately, there's Farmers Identity Shield. For just $65 or less per year, your credit is monitored.
Thank you for holding.
Plus, a personal fraud advocate helps make all those calls no matter how long it takes. So make only one now. 1-800-FARMERS.
Here's a tip. Order a Budweiser on draft. It's kept cold from the brewery to the distributor to the tap. Can't get a more refreshing Budweiser than that.
I thought I was supposed to tip you.
You still can.
For the Cubs, 7 runs, 15 hits, no errors, 9 left. For Milwaukee, 1 run on 6 hits, 1 error, 7 stranded. Zambrano gets the win. He's now 12-4 on the season. The losing pitcher, Ben Sheets, he drops to 10-4, 2 hours, 35 minutes in front of 45,069 here in Milwaukee. Bob, the Budweiser play of the game. We go back to that Kosuke Fukudome two-run triple.
Yeah, the biggest hit in that five-run inning. A lot of highlights in the ballgame tonight, but we're going to give our Budweiser play of the game to Kosuke Fukudome, showing some signs of snapping out of his slump.
The perfect balance of taste and refreshment, Budweiser, the great American lager. Our next broadcast of Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN Sports will be Thursday afternoon from right here in Milwaukee, series finale. Rich Harden still going after that first win as a Cub. We'll face right-hander Dave Busch. And we'll be on the air at 1 o'clock Central Time, celebrating 60 years of Cubs broadcasts on WGN Baseball like it ought to be. This was Cubs baseball like it ought to be tonight. 7-1 the final.
Nothing to it. You hit it well, you pitch it well, you catch it well, you win.
Be right back at it tomorrow, and we will see you Thursday afternoon. Again, the WGN News is coming up next with the live sports from Milwaukee from Dan Rome.
Chicago Cubs baseball, brought to you by Budweiser. Reach for the perfect balance of flavor and refreshment. Budweiser, the great American lager. The Chicagoland area Dodge dealers and the all-new 2009 Dodge Journey. AT&T. See what's new from the new AT&T. Visit att.com for details. The Illinois Lottery. Play the Illinois Lottery. Have a ball. By Pepsi. Every sip gets you closer. And by Southwest Airlines. Fees don't fly with us. Visit southwest.com.
Andrea Barrow is a real Geico customer, not an advertising spokesperson. So to help tell her story, we hired one.
One day a rock chipped the windshield on my car.
Oh dear, broken glass sends shivers down my bottle.
I filed my claim at geico.com and scheduled an appointment.
It was a piece of cake, or maybe more like hot pancakes.
The repairman came right to my house and fixed my baby like new.
Now I feel rich, thick and buttery too.
Geico, real service, real savings.
Oh, someone has put a logo right over my face.
The men of TV are de-evolving from man of the house.
I am the king in my castle.
To man of the couch.
Haven't I heard of you?
You're not a cop, are you?
Just when you think it can't get any worse, these guys show up.
I'm Larry. This is my brother Daryl. That's my other brother Daryl.
Watch the men of classic TV go from sophisticated to sauced. Put your mind on rewind with Out of Sight Retro Night on WGN America. Keep your eyes here. Join the Night Watchman as he secures the fortress in an ongoing quest to keep it safe from mediocre television. Travel deep down to the movie underground to screen another movie mined fresh from the vaults. This Friday, we got the best Bond, and we're showing you his first outing as the infamous 007.
Bond. James Bond.
Pierce Brosnan stars in GoldenEye. Enter the movie underground Friday night at 80s 5 West right here on WGN America.
Shaken, not stirred.
I just quit smoking. You won't make it till 6 o'clock. You got yourself a bet.
Like taking candy from a baby.
That's Becker.
I'm so pathetic.
Becker, tonight at 12:30.
This is Chicago's very own WGN News at 9.
The kitchen is closed at a popular restaurant chain. The Bittigan's bus catches many customers and employees by surprise. Good evening, I'm Allison Payne.
And I'm Mark Sapelsa. WGN's Tom Negevin has our story tonight. Tom?
Hey, you guys. Well, you know what? It's one of the biggest restaurant bankruptcies in American history, and a lot of Bittigan's employees arrived at a couple of very popular Michigan Avenue locations and learned the news as they got to work today. The familiar red neon sign still burns. The tables are still set. And while the banner reads open for breakfast, this Michigan Avenue Bennigan's won't likely open for anything ever again.
They're always busy. I just don't understand. But it's the way the economy is, I think.
It's a nationwide shutdown by the popular chain's Texas-based parent company, closing hundreds of locations, laying off thousands of employees, including those at two Michigan Avenue restaurants. The Chapter 7 filing implies existing assets would be liquidated. The company closed for good.
That is shocking. That is truly shocking.
Shocking to a lot of people today.
I still don't really know what's going on, to tell you the truth. Just showing up for work.
Including a lot of now former Bennigan's employees.
I can't believe that this happened. It's just out of nowhere.
There was no warning. There was nothing.
I didn't get a phone call or email or anything.
Today, workers gathered outside their Bennigan's in Calumet City, still taking the bad news in. Just last night, 61 people worked here. Employees now left to worry about money they're already owed. There's been no word on checks or on back pay.
I don't have a job anymore. And in this day and age, in this economy, it's rough.
Rough all around, a big sign of the economic times we are in. And how much average Americans are doing to curtail their discretionary spending? Economists telling us that what happened to Bennigan's is just a sign of that. This closure does not affect franchisee-owned outlets, and those owners want to make sure we pass that along.
Yeah, three or four of those here in northern Indiana still open, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
Okay, Thanks.
We have the dirtiest beach water in America. So says one environmental group looking at how much bacteria we're swimming in. The Natural Resources Defense Council reports 23% of samples taken from beaches along Lake Michigan last year had bacteria levels higher than what's considered safe for swimming. That compares to 7% nationally. The report, though, does give Illinois kudos for addressing the problem because Illinois tests beaches more frequently than many other states.
Sulfuric acid was the chemical used in an attack on a Logan Square woman. Someone threw the acid at Esperanza Medina yesterday as she was getting into her car and grabbed her purse. Surveillance video shows these images of the alleged attackers, a man and two women. Medina's family is begging anyone with information to come forward.
Someone out there has to know something that happened, has to know who these people are. You've showed the clips. Someone has to know their faces. There has to be someone. I'm asking the public to please, please, it could be your mother, it could be your daughter that this could have happened to.
Ms. Medina is in stable condition in the burn trauma unit at Strozier Hospital. The family says this isn't the first time that she's been threatened.
All of a sudden, I was about to sip on my coffee, and the whole thing started to shake up.
A strong earthquake striking Southern California, damaging buildings, bursting water mains, sending store products crashing to the floors. Amazingly, just a few injuries. The magnitude 5.4 quake hit 29 miles southeast of downtown L.A. near Chino Hills. Reporter Cara Finstrom is there firsthand with her account.
A moderate earthquake strikes Southern California just east of Los Angeles. At the airport, a pipe burst and water caused tiles to fall from the ceiling at a gate. And take a look at this. Taping was in progress for the new TV show Family Court when the rumbling began.
Relax. Stay calm. Stay
earthquake.
Calm. It's okay, everyone, get under the desk.
CNN meteorologist Chad Myers said the earthquake was fairly close to the Earth's surface, and that's the kind that produces stronger shaking.
Everybody ran outside. We all ran outside.
The earthquake was felt more than 50 miles to the north of L.A. and as far south as San Diego. It was followed by more than 30 aftershocks. California Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger says the state's emergency services are on standby to help if needed.
I think that we were very lucky with this one. And I would say that the fires that we have had, you know, that was much a bigger damage that was caused in California. And but I mean, we hope that there are no more major aftershocks.
The governor says we should expect to hear more reports of minor damage coming in throughout the night. He also says that teams have been dispatched to check on the overpasses, bridges, and other infrastructure throughout the state to make sure that it's sturdy and safe. In Los Angeles, I'm Cara Finstrom, WGN News.
Breaking news on the west side. Body has been discovered in a basement of a building that houses a church in the 5300 block of West Division. Authorities say the body was burned. We have a crew in the scene. More information will come as soon as they pick it up for us. Coming up, bad bridges. They're everywhere, says a new report. And without some fiscal attention, some are worried something bad could happen.
Bob Barker brings his showcase showdown to the Chicago City Council.
90 degrees, felt like a sauna today. Tom Skilling planning for more the same in his forecast. Hi, Tom.
You're watching WGN News at 9 with Allison Payne, Mark Sapelsa, Tom Skilling, and Dan Rohn. This is Chicago's very own WGN News at 9.
Oh, hey, I'm the night watchman here at the Fortress of Television Innovation. My job takes me from the top to the very bottom of this mighty structure. It's up to me to keep the fortress safe and secure from mediocre television. So one day, I discovered a vault filled with movies and created myself a secret getaway. I call it the Movie Underground.
Enter the Movie Underground Friday night at 85 West right here on WGN America.
Become one with molten chocolate. Celebrate your right to indulge. It's time for Warm Delights Minis. Just seconds in the microwave, 150 calories, and you'll see how something so many can take you so far.
Did you know that 1 in 5 American adults has genital herpes? That's because so few people know they're spreading it. My patients really try to be careful, but many are surprised to learn they can still spread herpes between outbreaks. So you can give herpes to your partner at any time, even without signs or symptoms. The CDC recommends daily medication as part of a plan to reduce the risk of spreading genital herpes. Once daily Valtrex is the only medicine proven to reduce that risk.
Always use safer sex practices with daily therapy, which also includes avoiding sexual contact when you get or think you're getting an outbreak. There's no cure for herpes. Even with treatment, it's possible to spread herpes. Valtrex is for adults with healthy immune systems. To avoid a potentially serious complication, tell your doctor if your immune system isn't normal because of bone marrow or kidney transplant or advanced HIV disease.
I have genital herpes.
And I still don't.
And now we're doing more to help keep it that way.
Ask your doctor about once daily Valtrex and save up to $10 on every 30 caplets at Valtrex.com.
Is Chicago's very own WGN News at 9.
Illinois Governor Rod Blagojevich used the one-year anniversary of the Minnesota bridge disaster to warn about the state of our state's bridges. But the most powerful lawmaker in Springfield won't be crossing that bridge anytime soon with the governor. So what's the problem? WGN's Julie Unruh in the newsroom to unravel it for us. Julie.
This week marks the one-year anniversary of the Minneapolis bridge collapse. 13 people died that day, and more than 100 were hurt. Today, the governor's office here in Illinois says it doesn't want to scare people, but right now, 765 bridges are considered structurally deficient in Illinois. And if the proposed $34 billion capital plan doesn't get passed, $90 million slated to fix those structures will soon be water under the bridge.
I'll often say, our bridges are talking. Are we listening?
That from the Bureau Chief of Bridges in Illinois. He's afraid cracked concrete, rusty railings, and unsafe steel beams could leave our state scrambling if it all gave way. Could it? You bet. Just ask the people of Minneapolis. Vehicles plunged to the bottom of the Mississippi River almost 1 year ago when Interstate 35 West fell apart. Here in Illinois, age and traffic are wearing down our bridges.
The soaring costs of concrete, steel, diesel fuel, and asphalt are reducing the number of projects that states, including the state of Illinois, can fund.
1 out of 4 bridges in the U.S. needs to be modernized or repaired, proving the argument is real. But this time, the motive is political.
It's time to put the politics aside. It's time to put whatever personal dysfunction some might have towards others aside and come to the table and work in a constructive way to meet our responsibilities to the citizens of this state.
But House Speaker Mike Madigan won't play ball. Through a spokesperson, Madigan's office made it clear, saying, "We've determined that a meeting with Governor Blagojevich is not a productive use of Speaker Madigan's time. We believe there is a need for a capital plan, but we need to use our time wisely."
It's about making sure that what happened a year ago in Minnesota doesn't happen here in Illinois.
IDOT officials maintain Illinois bridges are safe, but depending on funding, the debate is repairs versus replacements. The governor has called for a meeting this Thursday in his office to talk further about the stalled capital plan. Speaker Madigan won't be there.
Julie Unruh reporting in our newsroom. Thousands of CTA customers discovered sudden charges from their bank accounts. A technical glitch at a large majority of the Fare Card Express vending machines recently discovered. From March through mid-July, those machines were authorizing credit and debit card transactions but weren't actually receiving the money. All those payments were finally processed this week. Some customers were slapped with overdraft fees because they didn't have enough money for the sudden charges. About 400 customers were also accidentally overcharged, a total of $9,000.
Bob Barker came on down to a Chicago City Council meeting today. He was here to support an ordinance that would make it mandatory for all dogs and cats over the age of 6 months to get fixed. WGN's Marcella Raymond has that story.
When Bob Barker came on down to the City Council floor, he got a standing ovation. Barker is traveling the country, testifying before the councils in major cities, imploring them to put a law on the books making it mandatory to have dogs and cats spayed or neutered. He wants Chicago aldermen to pass a law as well.
We come to this wall, which is seemingly impossible to get over. The only answer is legislation.
The aldermen supporting the proposal, Burke, Rugai, and Schulter, say neutering will cut down on dog fighting and dog attacks in the city. They say it will also cut down on the number of animals euthanized every year because of overpopulation. Animal Control alone put down 14,000 dogs and cats in 2006.
It is a win-win situation in that you save taxpayers money and you save animals from suffering.
I agree with everything you've done before until today.
Alderman Ray Suarez says fixing your dog or cat should be up to you.
And I happen to be a pet owner, and by choice, I did that. By choice. I don't like when government gets involved in everything to try to solve problems.
At Wrigley Field Doggy Park on the northwest side, the dogs play well together. Of course, they're all fixed.
In the city, there's so many dogs so close together. Dogs that haven't been spayed or neutered are typically pretty aggressive, and so I think it can be a threat in the city to other dogs sometimes.
Well, I think it just comes down to the person's discretion. Mm-hmm. I think it's about being responsible, and I believe that as so long you're not in the business of breeding, I think it's only right that you should have your dog spayed or neutered.
Marcella Raymond, WGN News.
So tell us what you think. Should pet owners be forced to spay or neuter their animals? Text yes or no to 97999, or you can vote online at WGNTV.com. Stay with us. We'll have results after Tom Skilling's forecast.
Join the Night Watchman as he secures the fortress in an ongoing quest to keep it safe from mediocre television. Travel deep down to the movie underground to screen another movie mined fresh from the vaults. This Friday, we got the best Bond, and we're showing you his first outing as the infamous 007.
Bond. James Bond.
Pierce Brosnan stars in GoldenEye. Enter the movie underground Friday night at 80s 5 West right here on WGN America.
Shaken. Mustard.
The men of TV are de-evolving from man of the house.
I am the king in my castle.
To man of the couch.
Haven't I heard of you?
You're not a cop, are you?
Just when you think it can't get any worse, these guys show up.
I'm Larry. This is my brother Daryl. That's my other brother Daryl.
Watch the men of classic TV go from sophisticated to sauced. Put your mind on rewind with Out of Sight Retro Night on WGN America. Keep your eyes here.
That's me, Dr. John Dorian. My friends call me JD.
Look what I confiscated from one of the kids in pediatrics.
Ow!
What, too hot?
Yeah! I'm an intern at a hospital that could use a little therapy.
They're doing a breast reduction on three, and I want to get up there and try and stop it.
In fact, sometimes things around here are so strange, they can make a TV show about it.
There's no beer.
We had a few.
Newsflash, you can't drink and then come to work. You're not airline pilots.
They could call it Scrubs.
I'm no Superman.
Nah, my job is right here.
Sorry, if that gets infected, I'm a doctor.
Saving lives at Sacred Heart.
Is anybody else a doctor? What's going on down there?
Scrubs, 7 nights a week at 11 East, 8 West.
In tonight's Medical Watch, allergic to alcohol.
A new study finds consuming alcoholic beverages can lead to chronic allergic rhinitis. Now, the research in the Journal of Clinical and Experimental Allergy finds the risk for long-term sinus problems increases 3% for every additional alcoholic drink per week. Scientists found the study participants followed them for 9 years and found those who had 2 drinks per day had a 78% chance of having the chronic upper respiratory disorder.
Accidental overdoses are on the rise. Researchers say the number of fatal medication errors inside the home is soaring. The Archives of Internal Medicine reports more medications are being taken outside hospitals with less supervision from doctors.
Drugs that help kids focus and stay calm, but they may break their hearts. The American Heart Association urging doctors to check children's hearts before prescribing stimulant medication for attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Drugs like Ritalin and Adderall and others carry a risk for sudden death and problems with kids with heart problems since they increase blood pressure and heart rate. But the American Academy of Pediatrics says most children don't need the heart screening. More heat, more rain? Well, it is summer in Chicago as we approach August. But next, Tom Skilling picking out what could be the hottest day of the year.
Nice if everything in life came with a worry-free guarantee? Well, at Rent-A-Center, everything does. With our worry-free guarantee, we'll match any competitor's price on brand-new, brand-name merchandise. No credit hassles, delivery, setup, and service included. And you gotta love it or your money back. Rent-A-Center. We make it easy to make it your own. It's the worry-free summer cruise and sweepstakes at Rent-A-Center. $1 million in cash, cars, and prizes. Winners every day. Hurry into Rent-A-Center or visit worryfreesummer.com to enter.
We all have internal plumbing, but for some of us, it can be a problem. You know, frequent, sudden bladder urges. You worry your pipes might leak, so it's hard to always do things spur of the moment. If you've had enough, talk to your doctor about taking care with Vesicare. Vesicare, once a day, can help control your bladder muscles so it can help reduce urges and leaks day and night. If you have certain types of stomach, urinary, or glaucoma problems, do not take Vesicare. While taking Vesicare, if you experience a serious allergic reaction, severe abdominal pain, or become constipated for 3 or more days, tell your doctor right away. Common side effects are dry mouth, constipation, blurred vision, and indigestion. Fewer urges, the chance to be more spontaneous. Vesicare can make a difference. Ask your doctor today about taking care with Vesicare.
Power and the fresh scent of Febreze Noticeables everywhere. It's a breath of fresh air.
You know where I am? The intersection of my inbox is out of control and haven't had a day off since the third grade. You know, the place where you can't get a minute to check your voicemail, let alone shop for car insurance? Yeah, you could say I'm there.
State Farm makes it easy to get our Good Neighbor service and discounts on your terms. Get a quote day or night, online, on the phone, or in person. Whatever works for you. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
WGN America, TV you can't ignore.
Tom's here. It's been like changing within the minute here.
It has.
You can kind of feel it rumbling as it was coming in.
Oh, absolutely. Rick Strasser at our assignment desk called me to say that there are now reports of street flooding in parts of the north side here by WGN. We have lots of lightning, and the rains are coming down hard in some areas. And that's been the case across southern Illinois, central Illinois, actually, across the state, and back through Missouri and Kansas, where these storms started this morning. There have been places like Rock Island that have had 2 inches of rain. The clouds have towered to 58,000 feet. We'll show you our three-dimensional satellite and radar imagery in just a bit. But here's how it all started, as it often does, with some boiling cumulus clouds set into motion by the heating of the day, which saw us up to 89 degrees at Midway and the lakefront today and 88 at O'Hare. But temperatures have tumbled. That rain's mixed down the cooler air. It's still pretty humid. It's 75 at O'Hare. And look at the 17-mile-an-hour sustained winds. They're 21 miles an hour at Midway Airport. It's 75 there. And there have been gusts of 38 miles an hour with these storms, according to our sensors down in that area and our Frank Wachowski. Look at the highs across the metro area today. There were actually a number of 90s, among them up in Janesville, down in southwest suburban New Lenox, northwest suburban Libertyville, and in northwest Indiana at Griffith, it was 91 today. But current temperatures have reacted to the rain, and so there's been kind of a nice cool down. down. It's going to stay pretty humid the rest of the week, though, and temperatures will bounce back up not far from 90 tomorrow and could brew a couple of new storms after these things exit the area in the next couple of hours. Dew points are hovering not far from 70. Look at the big storm clouds come into the DeKalb area. That's pretty dramatic, and here's a shot from downstate Decatur showing the storms that swept that area. So these things are occurring all the way out to Kansas, where in Wichita you can see the rain shafts going through the state, and up in Wisconsin at Crivitz out not far from Lake Winnebago. Look at the storms that have covered the area there. The whole pattern is being driven by incredible heat down in the south that saw Memphis at its hottest temperature of the year, triple digits today. And this blistering heat is showing signs of spreading out as we get into the weekend and early next week. Could bring us some mid-90s around the area, maybe 95 to 97 on Monday if everything works just fine and we don't get some thunderstorm outflows. Our storms today originated actually from this cluster right here, part of which are the remnants of Tropical Storm Dolly. And you can see how the rains have fanned out across parts of Missouri and southern Iowa and into Illinois. Some of these rains came down at the rate of 1.9 inches in just an hour's time. And no wonder we live in a sea of elevated dew points and humidity. There's almost 2 inches of water evaporated in the atmosphere, tangling with the daytime heating in this jet. But look at this speed max rounding the bend here. The air sinks on the nose of those things beneath them, and that's what may puff this dome of warm air out of the southern plains and bring it up to the Midwest. Here's our three-dimensional and animated satellite imagery. Look at the towers of clouds. These things, according to Doppler scans, reach heights of 58,000 feet at times today. And here you can see them starting to collapse as they come across the Chicago area. But if you're watching a monsoon outside the window, you're under one of these things right now. And that's why it rains so heavily, because the cloud actually is tall there. And it's got a big shaft of moisture above you, which can concentrate that rainfall like a few other storms on Earth. The Doppler plot of rainfall that's come down shows that central Illinois was favored. There have been 68 mile an hour wind gusts in parts of LaSalle County, and our RPM model says we're not done. These are the storms going across the area now, but our model is developing some new storms around 5 in the morning in much of the metro area, and then suggesting scattered storms will redevelop during the afternoon as we heat up. So by 4 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon, there could be more storms, but they'll be scattered. Not everybody will see them. And the same thing could happen on Thursday. Little wind off the lake Saturday may delay the onset of the worst heat on Saturday, but Sunday afternoon, after some morning thunderstorms, it gets hot and probably fairly brutally hot on Monday. Well, cloudy warm tonight. Some scattered showers and storms will be passing from the area in the next couple of hours. Low temperature down to 69, but one or two may refire late tonight. And the southwest winds will be blowing at 5 to 15. Look at that rain coming down on Michigan Avenue. It's coming down in buckets down there, and the flashes of lightning are evident too. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, hazy, warm, and humid. There could be some scattered thunderstorms developing. They'll be landing early tomorrow night, as you see there, but partly cloudy and muggy, low down to 39, a light wind. And on Wednesday, mixed sun and clouds, and could be some scattered thunderstorms again in the afternoon or evening. We'll have a high temperature going back into the upper 80s. Now, the 7-day forecast we'll have in about 10 minutes. Mark and Allison, so stay tuned.
Hope it's drier. Okay.
It is. Thank it's a lot hotter, I can tell you that.
All right. Thank you.
See you later, guys.
All right, Tom.
Told you earlier about the Chicago proposal that would require all cats and dogs in the city older than 6 months to be spayed or neutered. In our poll, 35% of you said pet owners should be forced to spay or neuter their animals. 65% say no, that crosses the line. Thanks for voting.
It is all the buzz. Who will Barack Obama pick for his vice presidential running mate? Political insiders now say there's a new leader in the VP sweepstakes, Virginia Governor Tim Kaine. Senator Obama says he is still undecided and spent most of his time today talking about the economy. He met with the Secretary of the Treasury and plans on sitting down with the Federal Reserve Chairman, too. In the hotly contested state of Nevada, Republican John McCain was talking tough about the economy as well. McCain's wife, Cindy, introduced him to a cheering crowd where he told voters he would keep taxes low and would not raise them. The senator was trying to clarify earlier statements he made about possibly raising Social Security taxes. Sports is next after last night's clunker. The White Sox try and even the score tonight against the Twins.
And after a nail-biter last night for the Cubs, Carlos Zambrano. Did he make it look easy for the Cubs tonight? Dan Rowan live in Milwaukee next in sports.
The Z has come back with back to back.
Chappelle Show, Friday night at midnight East, 9 West on WGN America.
From the very first moment we arrive, we're on the move. And we don't want anything, ever, to slow us down. So it's surprising that 80% of women aren't getting enough calcium. But thankfully, with over 25 great flavors like strawberry cheesecake and blackberry harvest, Yoplait gives you 20% of your daily calcium and vitamin D in every cup. Yoplait, it is so good.
Live from WGN-TV Chicago, the official drawing of the Illinois Lottery.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Linda Kohlmeyer with your winning lottery numbers for Tuesday, July 29th, 2008. So I wish you the very best of luck. Let's go. The first game is pick three. The first lucky number is 8. Second number, 8. And your third and final pick three, 9. That makes the winning pick three numbers for tonight, 8, 8, 9. Time for the pick four game. I hope your day from sunrise to sunset to now is majestic. Here we go. The pick four. First lucky number, 2. The second number, 3. Your third lucky number, 1. And the fourth and final pick four for tonight, 5. That makes the winning pick four numbers for tonight, 2, 3, 1, 5. It's a little out of time of the jackpot, but it's $100,000. Best of luck to you. The first winning little lotto number for tonight, 6. Your second, 35. Third, 36. Fourth, 29. And the fifth and final little lotto number, 2. That makes the winning little lotto numbers for tonight, 6, 35, 36, 29, and 2. I hope those were your lucky numbers. I'm Linda Kohlmeyer. Good luck and good night.
Tonight's lottery drawing was brought to you by WGN-TV and supervised by the accounting firm of Clifton Gunderson.
Few people know they're spreading it. My patients really try to be careful, but many are surprised to learn they can still spread herpes between outbreaks. So you can give herpes to your partner at any time, even without signs or symptoms. The CDC recommends daily medication as part of a plan to reduce the risk of spreading genital herpes. Once daily Valtrex is the only medicine proven to reduce that risk.
Always use safer sex practices with daily therapy, which also includes avoiding sexual contact when you get or think you're getting an outbreak. There's no cure for herpes. Even with treatment, it's possible to spread herpes. Valtrex is for adults with healthy immune systems. To avoid a potentially serious complication, tell your doctor if your immune system isn't normal because of bone marrow or kidney transplant or advanced HIV disease.
I have genital herpes.
And I still don't.
And now we're doing more to help keep it that way.
Ask your doctor about once daily Valtrex and save up to $10 on every 30 caplets at Valtrex.com.
Happiness is fat money, so we've extended our big fat rate even longer. Now until September 15th, enjoy a pudgier, porkier, portlier 3.50% APY. That's 9 times the national savings average. So get your skates on. Open an HSBC Direct Online Savings account today, and you'll say goodbye to skinny savings. Brought to you by HSBC, the world's local bank.
Well, I married my dream girl, I married my dream girl, but she didn't tell me her credit was bad. So now instead of living in a pleasant suburb, we're living in the basement at her mom and dad's. No, we can't get a loan for a respectable home just because my girl defaulted on some old credit card. If we'd gone to freecreditreport.com, I'd be a happy bachelor with a dog and a yard.
Offer applies with enrollment and triple advantage.
Becker, weeknights at 12:30 East, 9:30 West on WGN America. It's not a dream. You are not hallucinating. You're witnessing the metamorphosis of a new network. WGN America. Keep your eyes here.
The Sox and the Metrodome did not agree last night. Let's see if they could rebound tonight while the Cubs try and make it two straight in Brewtown.
And Milwaukee is where WGN Sports Director Dan Rome joins us live tonight. Dan.
Hey, Allison and Mark. Yeah, I heard you guys were having some weather down there in Chicago. The only thing it was raining up here was base hits for the Cubs. A shockingly easy victory over Milwaukee tonight in a matchup between the staff aces here at Miller Park. Ben Sheets of the Brewers and Carlos Zambrano of the Cubs. Zambrano had a terrific night. The only angst he suffered was when he failed to put down a sacrifice and snapped the bat over his knee here. On the mound, he was terrific. 8 scoreless innings, 9 strikeouts, and his teammates really backed him up in the 6th inning. 7 consecutive hits. The big one, Kosuke Fukudome here. This goes for a 2-run triple. The Cubs scored 5 runs in the inning and took a 6-0 lead. They tacked on one more in the ninth. Aramis Ramirez had 3 doubles and this RBI single. As the Cubs win it 7-1, their lead is 3. They just beat Sabathia and Sheets back-to-back. But after the game, Lou Piniella wanted to talk about his pitchers.
Our two guys, Lilly and Zambrano, aren't exactly chopped liver. They're pretty good pitchers. They're two good pitching matchups. Now, we respect, obviously, the two guys that we beat. But anytime we run Lilly and Zambrano out there, we got Dempster, we got Harden, we're throwing some darn good pitching out there ourselves.
And the lineup that they have is a pretty good lineup. You don't have to make a mistake. You have to go to with your A game and with a good game plan, and that was what I did today.
Might have been Zambrano's best outing of the entire season. As for the White Sox, Mark mentioned it, a rough night for them. Never in the game against Minnesota last night. Tonight they were, but could they hang on at the finish? That was the big question as the rookie outfield pitcher Clayton Richard took the mound tonight.
Dapa.
And the Sox backed him up early on in the 2nd inning. And Josh Fields got all over one down the left field line. It goes for a 2-run double. Tomey and Ramirez score. It's 3-0. The Sox had the lead. And they would add on in the 5th inning thanks to Brian Anderson. This is a solo shot for Anderson, number 6 on the year for him, and a 4-0 lead. But in the bottom of the 5th, it all kind of fell apart on the young pitcher. 4-2, bases loaded, Justin Morneau up there, and he cleared him off. This double scores 3 runs, put the Twins up 5-4. They hang on to win it by a final of 6-5. The lead is now a half game over the Twins for the White Sox with 2 games left in the series at Minneapolis. Down south we go to Bourbonnais. Bears camp again this afternoon, and Olin Kreutz out there for the first time doing all the drills this season. The 11-year veteran bothered by an Achilles injury back out there working hard. The Bears are counting on him to anchor an offensive line that has a lot of work to do.
It takes a while. It takes a long time for the line, and then you got to factor in injuries and the way the season goes, and guys play 16 games and can keep the level play up. It takes a long time to evaluate an O-line. Pretty much takes a whole season, so we'll see how we do this year.
Brett Favre turned in those reinstatement papers today, so the next move is up to the Green Bay Packers. The Bulls reportedly close to a 6-year, $70 million deal with Lou Alding, who's imposed a Monday deadline on contract talks with his old team. And down in Champaign, Illini guard Jamar Smith has put his probation in jeopardy by allegedly being caught drinking in a campus town bar. The terms of his probation were that he was not supposed to do any drinking after being convicted of drunken driving a year and a half ago. And again, up here in Milwaukee, boy, I'll tell you what, as good as the Cubs can play tonight, 7-1, they beat the Brewers. That's two in a row in the lead in the National League Central, back up to three games. Reporting live from Miller Park, Dan Rohn, WGN News.
All right, drive safe with that rain tonight. Thanks, Dan.
And Tom Skilling, a 7-day that we hope is going to dry out a little bit eventually.
Well, Allison, we probably haven't seen the last of the rain, but I think the big story will be the heat that's coming as we get into later in the weekend, early next week. Look at the lightning in these storms draped across the area right now. We've had some real downpours. Boy, that batch in northern Lake Michigan is really humming away up there. And look at the warmth today, triple digits to the south. That's the stuff that starts expanding into the center of the country. In fact, this animation shows you just how that hot dome is supposed to expand eastward, and it'll cover the heartland by the time we get later in the weekend and early next week. The good news is it does break. It could do so in a very wet fashion, though, but toward Tuesday of next week. Looks like Monday may be the hottest of the next 7 days, with an 88 tomorrow and 87 on Thursday and Friday, 88 Saturday. Maybe a tad cooler near the lake, but only a tad cooler, and inland areas may hit 90 the next few days, but it'll be 92 Sunday and 95 Monday.
95.
So get those air conditioners ready. Oh, my.
Thank you, sir.
See you later, guys.
All right. That's the news for this Tuesday night. I'm Allison Payne.
And I'm Mark Sapelson. For all of us here, have a good night.
WGN America, your summer.